Is there anybody listening? Is there anyone that sees what's going on? Read between the lines, criticize the words they're selling. Think for yourself and feel.
Good morning and welcome back to the Trailer Park. I am Chanda-Masta and hopefully the Trailer Park is going out live. You guys know we are in the new studio this week. This has been a long time in coming and I feel so foolish because I thought you guys were hearing my sound effects the other morning. You guys know I got a Stream Deck a year ago and I've been trying to get my sound effects into like five different studios and we had them working the other day. They were great. And then we added a shadow cast and another monitor to my studio and here we are. Am I just talking into the ether all on my own? Let me see. Make sure we're actually live. Oh, yeah, I see me. Yay. Hello, Rumble. What's up, Rumble? We had a few viewers over there. Hey, the kick looks beautiful this morning. Love the kick. Let's get the slide deck in here. I'm a little discombobulated today, and I'm going to show you why in a second. But let me get our slide deck in here. Ah, there it is. I love all those transitions. They're great, aren't they? The new camera is amazing. Like, it's tracking. It's not blurry. So we've added a shadow cast and another monitor to my, actually two monitors. So I'm running four monitors up top. And then I have my small monitor down here on my desktop, which is running the studio. So the slide deck, we shall see how this goes today because I'm controlling it from another monitor. let's see. Wrong mouse. I have multiple mice now, right? Mice. Okay, there we go. Fair use, we are on YouTube this morning. You know what that means, that these are just my criticisms, comments, opinions. Don't come for me. If you are interested in anything I scratch the surface on, please go do your own research. I promise the information is out there and those call you conspiracy theorists if you find it, right? Good morning, Mastermind, Cold Fusion Gaming. Boy, we got a slow start this morning. Everybody hung over from the apocalypse. Is that's what's going on here? It kind of feels like it. Hey, Rokfin! I got more love over on the Rokfin than anywhere this morning. Popeye's hanging out over there. Jim, too. Good morning, Jim. Not sure if I will get to see the show today. That's okay, Popeye. That's okay. We appreciate you. We have the most loyal fan or viewers. You guys, you don't have to send me a message when you're going to miss a stream. I totally understand. You know, I'm friends with so many content creators and I am so busy. I spend 12 hours a day in this chair building these shows, finding content, you know, ripping, downloading, doing all the things I got to do. And I feel terrible because I don't get a chance to watch a lot of my friends, you know. I don't get to watch Pasta as much as I want to. I don't get to watch Fee as much as I want to. I don't get to watch Misty, which, hey, Misty's got a new show. Do you hear this? Yeah. April 21st, she's rolling out her new Misty Winston show. You can find that over on YouTube. She started a new channel and it's only got a few followers. So the Misty Winston show, go follow it, please. And there's some of my peeps. Now I hate that I have to look over here for my YouTube. What can I do about this? Let's wrong mouse. God, I have too many mice and my brain can't comprehend it. I haven't even smoked yet today, so Oh, there we go. I'll put it over there. Will that work? Maybe that'll work. What's up, Mastermind? We got Corky in the house today, along with Rad Angel and Vic. Vic, I got your email. Is that a new contact person? I'll have Oz look at it. I'll make sure he sees it. Cold Fusion Gaming and Mastermind are hanging out. Oh, there's Uncle Warren. Hey, Uncle Warren. What's up? I've got a good show. I've got a huge show. There's lots to talk about. You know what? That's not going to work. Maybe if I put the chat right there, I'm not looking over here to read the chat. What do you guys think? Does that work? I think that works. Gray Zone is live. Yeah, Gray Zone's been doing some great fucking work the last, well, they've always done great work, but boy, they're bringing it the last 6 months, aren't they? I think so, absolutely. Okay, this mouse over here. I'm going to show you guys. Look, check this out. Okay, so this is the new camera, right? And then we have this monitor here. And this monitor down here, and then go around the world, and you got that monitor up there and that monitor there and then the studio. So now you see why I'm so completely confused. I will get this down. I'm new to this, so hang in there with me. Hey, Jilly, good to see you. Good, glad you stopped by. Jilly sent me a bunch of stuff. I got a few things on the deck from Jilly. If you want to help me out, I could sure use it, man. All these upgrades, and if it wasn't for Animaris, we would not have YouTube Premium. We'd all be watching commercials. So thank you. Every single penny you guys donate to us goes back into this and back into me surviving. Oh, holy shit, Chanda. Yeah, I'm running a main studio. I mean, there isn't any more bells and whistles that I could have in this studio that a professional engineer doesn't have. You guys know when I started out almost 5 years ago, I started out on a crappy little laptop that had no power at all. I had my boyfriend's headset, a gaming headset, and microphone. And we have slowly got to this point. But I thought I would just do a couple of interviews about being inside the Democratic Party and what I saw. And now here we are years later. So that's all you. That's all you. And of course, my partner in crime, Oz, helping me out. So I never thought I would do an independent show on my own. I never thought I'd be engineering it on my own. Life just kind of takes you to strange places, and that's where we are. So we're hanging out together. So I appreciate you guys. It's all happened because of you. Come on. There's got to be an easier way. I can see myself over here, but control is down here. So I would like to control myself over there. There's the PayPal. Why is anybody else dealing with allergies? God, pollen count is super, super high. Okay, let's get this show on the road. Glad everybody's joining me. People are straggling in slowly this morning. Hit that like button and share this out. We are one of the most oppressed independent media channels, always have been, just by the company that we kept coming out of the gate. People don't find us unless you like us and share us. Share us to your friends, because YouTube's not promoting us, Rokfin's not promoting us, Rumble's not promoting us, and X is doing everything they can to make sure nobody sees our shit. So please, share and like. It's the only way we're going to get through. Let's see. I want to get the Rumble up real fast. Oh, I always have the wrong mouse. Yeah. Hey, Shane Piper 69. Love the new stadium. Ah, yeah, we do too. Definitely. Okay. We got to talk about the eclipse that we all survived, right? Aren't you so sad and disappointed? Fuck. I woke up so excited Monday morning thinking, oh my gosh, on the off chance that something good happens, we might not have to deal with this nightmare any longer. We still have to deal with it, sadly. Nothing happened. Fear, fear, fear. They fear-mongered us to death. I think they do that so that way when something bad's happening, we don't see it coming. So let's check these memes out. So sun grateful for even 4-minute break from humanity. Yeah, right? Oh my gosh. And here is a Muppet newsflash. Boo! Worst apocalypse ever. When I was a kid, I loved the Muppet Show, and these old dudes, I can't remember their name. Somebody in the chat will put it down. They were my favorite of all the Muppets, man, because weren't they funny? They were snarky, and I've always loved snarky humor, right? So they were always my favorite. Boo, worst apocalypse ever. It is true. Come on, other mouse. I don't know, maybe if I put this monitor here, but then I won't be able to see my studio. You know, when you live in a mobile home or a trailer, as we call it, there is no way to mount shit on the walls because literally it's paneling, right? You got a 1/4-inch paneling, probably 1/8 inch paneling, not even 1/4. And nothing will mount to it. So you got to find the studs, and the studs are 4 feet of fucking part. And so it makes it hard to put the stuff on the wall, if you know what I mean. Okay, do this. Breaking search results for why do my eyes hurt, and my eyes hurt have exploded after the total solar eclipse occurred. Oh, yes. Well, do we expect anything less from the dumbass humanity that we are? I mean, how many times have we been told, don't look at the eclipse, don't look at the eclipse? Oh, well, we all looked at the eclipse. You guys know I did. everyone who looked, just looked, you have 7 days. Oh, yeah, you remember that? The ring. The ring. If you saw the circle, you were going to die in 7 days. How many of those are there? Like, ring five or something? That movie actually did scare the shit out of me when I was younger, but the spoof, I like those comedy spoof spinoffs, you know. That one was hilarious. I can't remember what it was called, but it was funny. Shanda has the tech skills. I would be lost. Aw, thanks, Rad Angel. I'm learning. I am learning. This has all been a learning process for me. 5 minutes before I went live, I had no audio, and I figured it out on my own. I didn't even have to call Oz crying, so I guess I'm learning. Yeah. Normally, I call Oz, like, freaking out. I can't do my show. What am I going to do? And he always says, calm down. We'll figure it out. Do you guys know that Mercury is retrograde? Yeah, I'll tell April 25th. And you guys know Mercury retrograde fucks me up. And so how's Mercury retrograde going for you? Me? I'm flying. Yeah, that's the way it feels during Mercury retrograde. Didn't we just go through a Mercury retrograde like in December? Like, fuck, 4 of these a year? I'm over it already. Anyways, guess who didn't get raptured? Yeah, that's right. Me, you, all of us. So Trailer Park Pundit has been marked left behind from the rapture today. I need my damn sound effects. I'm so sad my sound effects aren't working because I have the sad trombone. Right? I have so many good. We're going to get them working. That has been the whole point. You guys know I have jumped studios for a year consistent now, trying to get that damn Elgato Stream Deck to work. And it works. I can zoom in and out, right? I can do this with it. But for some reason, it will not pick up my sound keys. And I even went in and tried to program them individually, and it didn't work. So if you guys got any ideas out there, let me know. Let me know. I know Reef and Indy, they use Stream Deck, so maybe somebody knows. Okay, so there was a lot of crazy video that came out after the apocalyptic eclipse, right? And we saw a UFO come out of Texas, right? Did you guys see that video? I didn't bring it because guess what? That's not a UFO. That is a plane that's up about 10,000 foot elevation higher than where you're seeing the shadow. It's a shadow cast. So, and a lot of the videos that we saw, they're lens blurs is what they are. Basically, the lens is capturing the light and casting it back off, right? So people are like, oh my God, there's two moons. What the hell? Did you guys see the two moon one? Yeah. It's like, no, there's not two moons. That is a reflection off of what you're looking at. Duh. I don't know. But then the flat earthers get involved and it is what it is. Let's check out this one. I thought this one was interesting because is it the devil's comet that they're seeing in this, or is it lens blur and it's just reflecting back? I don't know. You guys tell me. Oh, that's not how this works. Can I hit play?
All kinds of weird shit going on, bud.
I'm talking about.
Yeah, you saw that shit now. I try to tell you.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. That fucking thing going through the atmosphere.
That might be the devil's comet. They got something called the devil's comet.
Well, here we go.
Look that way.
It's smoke out here.
What is that? Maybe it is the devil's comet. We were told that you would be able to see the devil's comet with the naked eye. So maybe that is what they were picking up. That's the only footage I've seen that looks like it has, you know, the devil's comet. Jax is okay. I've talked to Jax since the apocalypse. And no, sadly, she didn't get raptured either. I guess we're all just terrible. I don't mean to brag, but this is like the 10th end of the world I've survived. It really is. I survived Y2K. I survived 2012. I survived 2016. I survived 2020, 2021, 2022, 2023, and now 2024. So yeah, gonna keep on keeping on. What else can you do? Let's see. I'm moving it. Oh, did you guys see this? How fucking weird is this though? Okay, let me. I wish there was a way to make this stuff bigger. I will get bigger shots. I'm going to do like a full on camera of just the slide deck and like a full on camera of me. I'm just getting moved in. You guys know I'll get decorated and rearranged very soon. So this comes from True Stream Media. Somebody sent this to me. One of y'all. Maybe it was Anna or was it Natalie? Natalie sends me a lot of True Stream stuff. Check it out. This is just weird. So on the same day as the apocalypse, the guy known for predicting the existence of the new particle in 1964, the Higgs boson, passed away. What? Statement on the death of the professor Peter Higgs. It has been confirmed that Professor Peter Higgs has died at the age of 94. He passes away peacefully at his home on Monday, the 8th April, following a short illness. So this is the guy who predicted and found the Higgs boson particle of CERN. How fucking weird that he died right when they turned CERN back on, right? Maybe he got transported into another dimension. 94 years old. I'm going to guess that he had a pretty good long life. And, you know, it reminds me of our founding fathers. How many of our founding fathers died on July 4th, right? Like they held on knowing that July 4th was coming and they wanted to die on that day. It kind of feels like that. It just goes to show that when you're driven, you can hold on till you want to die. And I've seen it in the nursing homes where they won't die. Like until somebody comes to see them or, you know, they're waiting for something, their birthday. Very, very, very weird though. Maybe he got taken. What was the cult that was? Oh, the doomsday cult that they all committed suicide with the Nike shoes. Come on. They were waiting for an astrological event. It was some comet, right, that was going to pick them up or something like that. I'm throwing wrenches right now. If you don't have a wrench in the chat, let me know. Jody, yours is coming shortly. And I want to welcome a new viewer to the chat, Rich from WI. I'm assuming that's Wisconsin. Welcome to the chat. Welcome to the community. You are in good company here. And I know the chat's just going to love on you. That's what this chat does. You know, we might not have a lot of followers, but we have some of the best followers, right? We have good followers. We don't have bots like everybody else. Hello. Okay, you are now a mod, Jody, and so are you, Rich. Okay, gave everybody. Let me know though if you don't have a wrench or somebody doesn't have a wrench. I don't always catch the chat. You guys know. You know. Very weird. Okay, so moving on. This video broke yesterday. Okay, so last week we saw the Taiwan 7.8 earthquake is what it was. One of them was a 7.8, and I think one was 7.4. And I brought you video last week of people driving up kind of a mountain pass, and you see a major landslide coming, right? And they're all backing up in fucking huge rocks. It looks like it's something out of a video game or a movie. Huge rocks are just flying down and knocking these cars over. Well, this video, this is a composite video. There's a couple of different clips in it of drivers that were further into the mountain where the slides was actually happening. If you haven't seen this, this is, whoa, damn. It doesn't even look real. It's so terrifying. So let's play it. Kissing my ass goodbye and praying to God. This reminds me of White River, like going through Colorado. It's beautiful. You know, this is beautiful, this where this is. I can see why the U.S. wants Taiwan. How scary. How freaking scary. Oh my gosh. You're just praying that the mountain's not going to land on you, I guess, right? What can you do? Just ride it out and hope you survive. That's how we're all going to get through the apocalypse, right? You guys know I'm in a tsunami area, so kiss my ass goodbye. I'll be running. Because you guys know I don't have a car. I will literally have to run 5 miles up the hill. This is so scary. Is it safer to get under the overpasses? Is it not? I don't know, because everything's collapsing down on the overpasses, right? Your instinct is to get under it because it's going to barricade you and stop the world from falling on your head, but I guess in this case it worked out. But if it does crash, oh shit, this is so terrifying. Oh my god, yeah, there is bad, isn't it? Hey, Birdhouse Blues, good to see you over on the rumble.
What?
Oh my gosh, I'd be so scared. I don't know, I have a fear of being buried alive.
Oh no.
Oh, no. I'm scared of dark water and being buried alive. Oh, and being burned at the stake, too. you know, I burn myself every single day, and my family jokes it's because I come from a long line of witches who've been burned at the stake. And, like, there's days that go by, I'm like, oh, my God, I haven't been burned today. What the hell's going on? Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter if I'm cooking, I'm not cooking. I will always find a way to burn myself. Even if it's just smoking pot, I will burn myself. how terrifying. We haven't really seen any more video out since then, right? And I'm assuming that the tsunami was a no-go, right? We haven't seen that there was any tsunami that day, even though they kept saying there was going to be. Because, you know, once you get through the initial earthquake, it's a tsunami that's going to freaking get you. Let's move on. What do we got here? Let's see. Move that down. Trump says Jewish Americans who voted for Biden don't love Israel and should be spoken to. Oh, yeah? You going to do the speaking to? Let's see. This was April 9th. Republican presidential candidate, former President Donald Trump, speaks at a campaign event in Grand Rapids, Michigan on Tuesday, April 2nd. So he went to Michigan and told Jewish Americans who voted for Biden that they don't love Israel. Does this make any damn sense? Yeah, because it's going to get so much better under Trump, because Trump's so much different than Biden, right? Especially when it comes to his stance on Israel. Yeah. Hello, government. I would like to unsubscribe. Please, please. Is that a thing? Can we do that? We definitely need to do that. Moving on. Let me get out of the way. We want a ceasefire, yes, but our goal is liberation for Palestine. Actress Susan Sarandon speaks at a rally in NYC, joining thousands across the U.S. who demonstrated on Al-Aqsa Day for Gaza. That's not Alec, right? No, I like this. Ben and Jerry, Biden brain freeze bliss. Oh, my gosh. That would be his favorite, wouldn't it? Okay, let's check out Susan Sarandon. She always reminds me of my mom. My mom would dress like this. Come on, play.
It's been 181 days of inhumane lust for land, greed that has led to the destruction of so many homes and houses. And people and families and culture and the future for so many people. I'm going to read the statistics of what has been lost so far. Often when I speak, people twist my words in the paper. You cannot twist this. This is fact. The death, according to the Euromed Human Rights Monitor, the death toll in Gaza has surpassed 41,000, with an on average almost 90 children Jesus. Being killed on a daily basis. The death toll is 41,496.
And they're telling us.
Shame. Children killed, 15,000 plus.
It makes you sick.
Women killed, 9,671. Shame. Civilians killed, 37,676. Shame. Injured, 77,250. Journalists killed, 136. Shame. Displaced over 2 million. Healthcare professionals killed, 349.
War crime.
Healthcare professionals injured, 520.
War crime.
Civil defense workers killed, 42. civil defense workers injured, 156. Today alone, at least four people, including a paramedic, have been killed in an Israeli air raid that hit a rescue team in northern Gaza's Beit Hanun. According to health officials, the amount of food available to people in the north of Gaza is less than 12% of the recommended daily 2,100 calories intake per person, Oxfam said.
So terrible.
1,000 children in Gaza lost one or both of their legs. And four children are killed every hour.
Every hour.
In Gaza.
Every hour.
And this is being done with our tax money.
What genocide?
This is being done with a lot of apologies, but absolutely no action. This is being done in our name.
Our name with our money.
You cannot bomb your way to peace.
Nope.
And peace is not enough. We want a ceasefire. Yes. But our goal is liberation for Palestine.
Ah, love it when she hits the ground. She always gives a great speech. Case Study QB was on the ball yesterday. Oh my gosh, drop after drop after drop. So shout out to Case Study. Thanks for bringing it. Let's hear from Mr. BB himself. I think this is Pelosi. There's a bunch of Pelosi videos out there that we've unfortunately got to watch this morning. So let's watch the first one.
We were talking, Madam Speaker, in the commercial break as
Madam
you sat
Speaker.
Down.
Madam Speaker, she gets called that for the rest of her life,
of this
right?
This election, as yeah. you've seen them, you've watched
Madam
firsthand.
Fellow.
You were inside the Capitol on January 6th. You
oh, fucking January 6th.
Experienced a horrific incident in your own family because of the climate and the culture of
yeah.
what's going on.
Paul
right
and the hammer,
the so
which still doesn't
where do
make
you
sense.
See the stakes. What do you say to even some of those progressives who are protesting at your house?
The progressives.
We're not going to vote for Joe Biden because
Ooh,
of what
puppets.
He's doing in Israel. What do you say to voters who may be shaky on Joe Biden about the stakes of this one-on-one matchup?
Well, I don't know if they're progressives outside my house.
Oh, they're not progressives.
They outside my house, but in turn,
crazy
in
radicals work for Russia.
Forth. Yeah.
Yeah, but I know my protesters. I represent my district a long time. I got the biggest vote of any Democrat in California. They said,
I got the biggest vote of anybody.
No, I got the biggest
I
vote of any
I paid the
Democrat
most for it.
In California. So some of these people are, I don't know who they are. Some are the usual suspects, but largely.
I don't know who they are.
They're
all working for
Putin.
I don't
know what they are. But nonetheless, for those who
Hamas.
Are saying that, oh, you want Donald Trump? Donald Trump?
How is he any fucking different?
Muslim
He's better on the
thing?
Economy, I can tell you,
want
you
Donald
that.
Donald Trump, who says he wants people coming from nice countries? You want Donald Trump, who's anti-LGBTQ, anti-women's right to choose? You want Donald Trump, who was standing in the way
Orange
in,
man
of
bad. January
Republicans
6th.
In the House
of That's the only talking points they have. An abortion.
Assistance. To the Palestinians, to the tune of
but we gave you free college.
Dollars. What is their agenda?
Hey, Steve,
some
why
of
don't
it
you
is
have
spontaneous.
A we'll fix that.
Sincere and real and organic. Some of it, I make a distinction between
I see all the hammers in the chat.
And grassroots. And some of it is astroturf. So it's who benefits from it?
Who benefits from it?
Donald Trump.
Oh my God!
It's from Donald Trump.
Here we go again. Putin. If you don't support
There's
Biden,
in my view, a connection.
It's your fault,
here.
Trump.
We'll be talking to you much more as this election year goes
oh,
on.
Oh God,
Speaker
please
Emerita
don't.
Nancy Pelosi,
please
nice
don't.
To have you in New York
Thank
with
you.
Us this
yeah, and we fully intend to win the election. We're going to win the House.
We fully intend to steal the election.
And Chuck Schumer feels good about
oh,
the Senate.
Oh, Chucky's
so
in a mood.
We just have to. We've made a decision to win. We will win.
We made a decision. We're going to steal this one.
Thank you very much, Madam Speaker. Great to see you.
Nice to see you.
We talked about it. And, you know, the Democrats, we make a lot of fucking money when Orange Man Bad is in the White House. So we're going to pretend like we're going to fight him. And then when we lose, then you guys are going to give us money. You know, the Dems come out of this either way in a good place. Right. They look at how much they broke records fundraising when Trump was in the White House because they could reach out and cry to the liberals. They could put those talking points out there. Oh, but abortion. abortion. Oh, but, you know, the LGBT. Oh, January 6th. Give us money. Give us money. Give us money. And so it's not a loss for them if they lose in November. Absolutely not. 100%. The heat gets off of them a little because they don't have to keep answering for fucking Biden, right? That's the way I see it anyways. It's not going to matter, though. Both sides of the rotten bird, they support Israel and the genocide, isn't going to change much. Code Pink yesterday was blocking the halls of Congress and shut their lunch down. They went to the cafeteria and protested and said, no food for you, tell the food for Gaza, basically. I didn't bring the clips of this, but I did bring the clip of this from John James. Representative John James tweeted this out yesterday and said, fun fact, Code Pink, who's funded these protests, is funded by the CCP. Oh, yeah, that's right. And while these people try to distract from the fact that the hostages are still being held by Hamas, Israel is fighting a war to preserve its existence and keep the Jewish people safe. This was tweeted out by the same guy who's taken 165,000 plus from the pro-Israel lobby APEC. So, yeah, what do you think? You think he's got an ulterior motive for saying that Code Pink is sponsored by the CCP? And here's the funny thing. It got community noted and it said, yeah, there's no proof that the CCP has taken money from, or I mean that Code Pink has taken money from the CCP or from Russia. Imagine that. But, you know, these guys, they want to scream about misinformation and malinformation, yet they're the ones out there fucking tweeting it. So let's see about this protest. Boy, that was a short clip. Anyway, how gross, how disgusting. But I love whoever's doing this track APAC. Keep it up. Keep it up. Keep flooding X every day with these assholes. Every time they open their mouth, I want to see a tracker for it. I know I already threw a bunch of these on the Beauty and the Boomer deck, so we're going to keep bringing them. Here is Pelosi getting protested by students at Arizona State University, disrupting her. She hates it when she gets disrupted. And the left-wing authoritarians shutting down the Democratic Party. Liberals justify freaking out if the right wing was doing this to Biden. So, oh, you terrible liberals, how dare you come after a sitting president? Ugh, so crazy.
Nancy Pelosi, you are complicit in genocide. The blood of over 15,000 Palestinian babies is on your hands. How can you be a Democrat and say you hold democratic values while over 100,000 innocent Palestinian civilians have been massacred with bombs that you paid for? We will not be shamed into voting for you or Genocide Joe and your massacrist policy. My family back home in Palestine is being killed. Their blood is on your hands. And David Axelrod, shame on you and everyone of the Democratic elite that want to shame us for voting for Genocide Joe. 80% of Democrats.
Joe Biden's been the most advocate for the people of Palestine. That she actually just sat there and said that. Joe Biden's been the biggest advocate for the Palestinians. The fuck he has. Is that why we continue to send bombs? Is that why we're passing packages to build more bombs? Come on. She just loves to scream them down, though. It's so gross. This is so gross. Okay, so this is yesterday. Pentagon chief says there's no evidence of genocide. The U.S. has no evidence. I don't know what you're talking about. What genocide? Ugh, so gross.
Secretary Austin, thank you for acknowledging in response to Senator Wicker that Hamas committed...
He's looking pretty healthy after his whole cancer scare, I gotta say.
...by using human shields. I want to address what the protesters raised earlier.
Tom Cotton.
Is Israel committing genocide in Gaza?
No.
Senator Cotton, we don't have any evidence of genocide being created.
So that's a no. Israel's not committing genocide in Gaza.
We don't have evidence of that, to
Thank
my
you.
Knowledge.
Yeah. Better than Director Burns and Director Haynes did last month at the Intelligence Committee when they dodged that question. You stand accused by those protesters of greenlighting.
How
genocide.
Much does Tom Cotton take from
Would you like
APEC
to respond to that accusation?
What I would say, Senator Cotton, from the very beginning, is that we committed to help assist Israel in defending its territory and its people by providing security assistance. And I would remind everybody that, you know, what happened on October 7th was absolutely horrible. Numbers of Israeli citizens killed, and then a couple of hundred Israeli citizens taken hostage.
American citizens as well.
American citizens as well.
So you deny the accusation that you greenlit genocide?
I absolutely deny.
Okay. For the record, I don't think Israel's committing genocide.
Ah, you wouldn't. You wouldn't. Are we surprised? No.
About Israel's responsibility to provide aid in Gaza.
Somebody send me the tracker on this asshole.
To provide aid to Gaza. Israel was the victim of an
always been repulsed by Tom Cotton.
Why should they provide aid to their to the aggressor nation or aggressor?
They are the aggressors.
To the aggressors on October 7th.
Oh my God.
We didn't provide aid to Germany and Japan during World War II.
Yeah, we kind of did. See, even Lloyd's like, well, we did.
And assistance to many of the countries that we've operated in recently.
But not in World War II. If you had been in George Marshall's or Dwight Eisenhower's position in World War II, would you have wanted to provide aid to Germany?
I really do believe,
oh,
Senator, that if they want to create a lasting effect in terms of stability, then I think that something needs to be done to account to help the Palestinian people.
I get that, but they're in the
middle. I don't care about them.
Like we believe that too. After World War II, that's why we had the Marshall Plan. That's why we rebuilt Japan. Oh. But that was after the war was won.
We blew them up and burned them to the ground.
It's not Israel's responsibility to provide aid. It's certainly not our responsibility. But we're spending our tax dollars to build this giant pier.
We're also spending our tax dollars to freaking blow it up.
Who's going to be at the end of the pier on the shore taking aid from American
forces? Americans, because it's our pier.
That's
remember.
Still, being worked out, but there will be
see, I told you
that will help to distribute that aid.
It'll be Americans.
Hamas is in charge of Gaza. When aid goes to Gaza, Hamas doesn't divert it or commandeer it.
Is in charge of that.
And anybody operating in Gaza is under the thumb.
Any person in Gaza is a Hamas.
I just think it's very ill-considered.
Is what he's saying.
And I don't think it's going to end very well.
Oh my God, it's not going to end very well for you because the American people see through this fucking bullshit. You guys can keep playing your damn game, but you're losing more people every fucking day, every damn day, left or right. I don't care. Ah, the Dershowitz was out yesterday taking on Finkelstein. Did you guys see this? And the comments kind of blew me away. Like, people were defending fucking Dershowitz. Don't you guys know I can't stand this guy? This guy is a fucking monster, a monster who needs, and because he's a good dirty attorney, he knows how to cover his ass, and there's a special place in hell probably next to Rumsfeld for this guy. But let's hear
Professor Dershowitz, name me one legal international legal body or human rights organization. Name me one. I'll take the pause. Name me one.
That what?
That says the blockade of Gaza is not collective punishment. Name me one.
The Lawfare Project in the United States.
Project. I said, name me one international legal or political body.
It is.
One.
It is.
Everybody's listening now.
Legal body.
Piers Morgan has a very large audience. Name me one. Name me
international
or legal. Legal political body that says the blockade of Gaza is legal. Name me one.
Every organization that I have been associated with, the Lawfare Project, the project run by a woman named Leitner, and the International Project, were all concluded that the blockade is legal.
Also,
the Israeli Supreme let me finish. The Israeli Supreme Court, which is above reproach. And which
is above reproach.
The International Court of Justice has also, with limits, has said that blockades designed to prevent the bringing of rockets to Israel is lawful.
I hate that I can't bring your guys' comments up
sense.
Anymore.
What possible reason would there be for allowing a group in Gaza, a group of Hamas, to send rockets without trying to blockade them from bringing the rockets in and building tunnels? Use your common sense. Of course it's unlawful.
Okay.
Every country in the world.
He just said it was
exactly
unlawful.
The same as Israel
okay,
did
listen, I think, we've exhausted this part of the debate.
Yeah, now Pierce is like, oh shit, he admitted it's illegal. Yeah, you can see right through that. He admitted that it was illegal, and then Pierce got sweaty and jumpy and was like, oh, okay, I think we've talked about this enough. Yeah, so the Dershowitz rule, when one criticizes Israel for conditioning genocide in Gaza, one must condemn the unprovoked attacks on Israel by Hamas. Yeah, always bring up Hamas, right? It's always, always so gross. You guys know I can't stand Dershowitz. And Mastermind says, on Epstein Island, Alan Dershowitz was the one who said, deplane, deplane. We're going to talk about Epstein Island because there was some rumors going around yesterday about who bought Epstein Island. And sorry, guys, I got to debunk it for you. But we'll get to that in Hollywood Go F Yourself. For now, let's hear from Mr. Chucky Schumer himself because, hey, he's in a good mood. Remember, Pelosi told us that he's having the best day ever.
The Congress gavels back into session. I also urge Speaker Johnson and House Republicans to snap out of their paralysis.
Snap
out
of it.
And pass the Senate's National Security Supplemental. The situation in Ukraine is desperate. Speaker Johnson has now sat on his hands for 55 days as the National Security Supplemental has collected dust in the House. That's 55 days of America standing on the sidelines.
He's wearing an Israel pin.
While our friends
not
in
an American
fight
pin.
And die on the battlefield with no support. 55 days of our European allies wondering when the U.S. will step up. And with each passing day, Ukraine continues to run out of more ammo, continues to run out of soldiers, and continues to run out of hope that can successfully expel the Russians from their borders.
I think he's saying
Ukraine's losing. Let's be blunt. The biggest reason Ukraine is losing the war is because the hard right in the Congress has paralyzed the United States from acting. That's it. That's the reason.
That's the right.
Speaker Johnson.
The reason they're losing in Ukraine
he will
is
do the right thing for Ukraine, for America, and for democracy, or if he'll allow MAGA Republicans to hand Vladimir Putin a large victory. I'm confident that if the Speaker puts the Senate's National Security Supplemental on the floor, it will pass. It remains
sure
the best,
too.
Quickest, and most realistic way to get Ukraine the help it needs.
The best, quickest.
So again,
most
there
real
is
way.
A lot that the Senate must do in the coming weeks and months. And to
but
get
fuck
anything
the American
done
people. We don't do anything for the American people.
I thank my colleagues for their good work so far in 2024 and look forward to working with all of them to keep delivering.
Gotta
the
jerk
American
off
people.
The constituents.
Now,
oh my God, that was so gross. And what is he saying? He's saying Ukraine is losing the war and it's Republicans' fault because they're not sending them enough bombs and money. Don't you know? We know, if you've been paying attention, that it doesn't matter how much bombs and money we send Ukraine, they're going to continue to lose. That little skirmish is lost. It's a lost fucking cause. And we dumped what? Billions into it. I mean, just keep adding up the hundreds of millions we sent them that went into the pockets of whoever knows, right? Who knows who where it went? Let's see. What is this? John Hopkins study shows that 97.5% of Judaics living in Israel have absolutely no Hebrew DNA and are therefore not Semites and have no ancient blood ties to the land of Palestine at all. Wherein 80% of Palestinians carry ancient Hebrew DNA and thus are real Semites. Yeah, right. You guys know I got some Jewish heritage in me, but no way, no how do I absolutely in any way think that I have Hebrew DNA. I know my Jewish ancestors came from like Germany. I'm not going to pretend that some land in Palestine is where I came from. But you know, they all do because, hey, they could take a birther trip and get some waterfront property. Caitlin Johnstone says, if you still have any doubt that we live in a profoundly sick dystopian, as deranged as anything that ever's been imagined in fiction, take note of the fact that the most powerful empire in the history is currently trying to propagandize you into thinking about obvious genocide is fine. Yeah, Caitlin Johnstone, been a fan for many, many years. And yeah, she nailed that one. Don't be so shocked, Cornell. Your institutions support this shit. I don't know. Why is he always so shocked? Yeah, go back to your institutions. Elizabeth Warren. This grossed me out yesterday because I saw progressives over on Facebook pushing the first page of this quote, not the second page, just the first page. So Elizabeth Warren is the first U.S. senator to call events in Gaza a genocide. Oh, look at her. She had first one out the gate. As an application of law, I believe that they will find that this is genocide. How many babies have to be, murdered before it's genocide? Let's be very clear. No head of state, politician, or elected official should be praised for calling for a ceasefire 6 months into a genocide. Instead of praise, how about the question, what took you so long? Yeah, what took you so long, Warren? What took you so long? You know, Bernie does the same shit, right? After months and months and months of pressure, they'll throw that keyword out there, even though they don't fucking mean it. They never meant it, right? And when they say a ceasefire, like we got Harris to say it a few weeks ago, and then she backed it up with just a 6 week one, right? And then they always throw in the let the hostages go. They don't give two shits about Palestine, and we know it. History books will not be kind to Genocide Joe. We will make sure the future generations remember what he did to the people of Gaza. We will never forget. No, we will never forget. Biden makes history as the first sitting U.S. president sued for complicity in genocide. Or is it actually Joe Biden? Now, Jilly sent me this, these screenshot pictures here, and you guys know we're always talking about the fake masks, right? CIA loves these things. They've been using them for 20 fucking years plus. And Jilly, I think this does look like a mask. Look at the eyeball. Look at the freaking, it's not seating right. Why does his eye look like it's a half an inch behind? That totally looks like a mask. I'm sorry. It does. What do you guys think? Does it look like a mask? I think it looks like a mask. I absolutely do. I didn't bring the video on this because it was in Russian and there was no point. But basically, Russia came out yesterday. Russian investigation committee says that terrorists from the city hall, the concert attack, were paid by Ukrainian energy company Burisma. You remember Burisma, right? That's where Hunter Biden used to serve on the board of directors for a lot of money. What a fucking coinky dink, right? That Burisma paid those freaking terrorists? It's almost like they use Burisma to, funnel money into the Ukraine. What? No way. Obviously. Biden says, obviously. That is one of my favorite refaces that I made a long time ago. That one has been on the deck for many years now. And of course, that is Lady Gaga and Biden reface together. Obviously. Are we shocked by that? That Burisma was the ones that paid? No, not at all. Not shocked at all. AOC is very, very upset because she had to watch herself in an AI porn. Aw. AOC opens up about the trauma of seeing a deep fake AI porn of herself. There's a shock that comes with seeing yourself doing those things. Let's hear what she had to say to Colbert this week.
Republican Congressman Mike Turner and Michael McCall said that Russian propaganda has infected the Republican Party's base and the Republicans in Congress were repeating Russian propaganda on the House floor. Can I get a witness? Have you seen this? And what do you make of that kind of self-accusation?
Yeah, I think if you turn on any House oversight hearing in the last year, you will see Marjorie Taylor Greene and Lauren Boebert and all these folks engaged in wildly propagandistic rhetoric. And let's just rewind a second. Just went through an impeachment attempt on the President of the United States that was started with a source that Republicans used that was in communication with Russian intelligence. So you have bench here. You have the chairman of the House Oversight Committee, Representative Comer, take quote unquote evidence, an account from someone who was working with the Russian intelligence and tried to impeach and remove the President of the United States over it. This is serious.
How did they not know that, or did they know that this
Let's
was
connected Let's not talk about the Steele dossier that was paid for by the Clinton fucking
Counterfeiting
Foundation.
That, I think, is a very excellent question
that they tried to impeach Trump with, right?
Because
he won't come on.
They used Russian disinformation to try to impeach Trump.
It is a good question because when they hauled us all into the skiff, which is a confidential space to look at this, we were looking at this document and it's like, is this for real right now? And they proceeded. And so what they felt was in good faith or bad faith, I don't know. But I do think it is immensely serious that something got to this extent and got this far and has been platformed to the extent that it has. And thankfully, under ranking member Jamie Raskin, we were able to stop them in their tracks as well. So,
oh, my God. Okay, I clap. We don't know what she just said, but we're going to clap for it. That's what Colbert's audience does. She is a walking propaganda machine, 100%. How stupid was that? Just so bad. But it gets worse. I have much more on my deck, so let's check it out. They call me 007, zero things built, zero things better, $7 gas soon. I guess I'm lucky my car's broke down because I cannot afford $7 gas a gallon. I don't know about you. Let's hear what Biden had to say, if it really is Biden.
I also want to make, and I've been pushing this, and if I'm reelected, I'm going to push it hard.
If I'm reelected.
Is I want to make community college tuition free. So you won't need loans at all. We're cutting half
okay, Bernie.
The cost of going to college. If we do this, the economic gains will far outweigh the cost, and that's not hyperbole. That's the truth. This is in addition to the historic investments we're making to modernize our infrastructure.
This is called pandering.
Roads, bridges, high-speed internet, clean water for every American.
High-speed internet.
We need more qualified people doing this work.
America. Just like high-speed rail, right? Okay, so Biden came out yesterday pandering to the Democratic left. I want to give you free college. He stole that right out of Bernie's playbook, and it worked fucking beautiful. You should have seen the fools yesterday out there. Biden, oh my God, he's giving us free healthcare and free college. We all know that that's not going to be a reality, but hey, it'll get a bunch of people to vote for him. So at the end of the day, it is what it is. Come on. Go where you're supposed to go. There we are. Are you guys buying this shit? Are you buying that he is going to fight for free college, local colleges? I don't buy it one damn bit. But they could do it. They could do it very easy. Take half the fucking money that you sent to Ukraine alone and send it to the state-ran universities. And the local colleges, you could go. But that's not the reality in late-stage capitalism. That's going to fucking happen. No. But he's going to pander and he's going to tell people that. Just like, remember when Obama said, the first thing I'm going to do is codify Roe v. Wade. And then when he got into office, he said, yeah, that's not my priority. Not my priority. Why? Because they use it to strum up, sympathy and votes. And that's what they continue to do. And yeah, we're going to talk about the abortion issue. It's further down on the deck, but I thought we'd talk about the college thing first because Bernie jumped right on board with him because it was probably Bernie's idea. They probably went to Bernie and said, this talking point could really get us a lot of votes and it'd be really great if you could back us up. So that's exactly what Mr. Cog himself, Bernie fucking Sanders, did. And let's hear from Bernie. Let's see. Bernie says, let me applaud the president for using every possible tool to reduce student debt instead of giving more tax breaks to billionaires as Trump has proposed. President Biden is providing financial relief to millions of low-income and working-class Americans. It's the right thing to do. I could eat a bowl of alphabet soup and shit out a smarter statement. Ha ha ha. Yeah, I agree. I love those old guys. They're my favorite. This is just gross. It's pandering. And both times that they have rolled out legislation that would reduce student loan debt, it's always been people that actually have fucking money to pay their student loans that qualify for the debt relief. It's never the poorest, right? It never works that way. I hate to break it to you. It never works that way. So well-paid professionals do not need welfare. Early on, I announced a plan to provide over $40 million working and middle-class Americans with student debt relief. That didn't stop me from finding an alternative path to relief, he says. And then Biden's FLOTUS SCOTUS bribes voters, ignores real needs. Yeah. Biden's new student loan forgiveness plan helps mostly people who don't need it. And yeah, that's exactly what I'm talking about. It's mostly people who don't need it that are getting the debt relief at the end of the day. It's the people that are making $350,000 a year and they're carrying $70,000 in student debt because they became a lawyer or a teacher, or I mean, not a teacher. Teachers don't make that much. A lawyer or a doctor. And yeah, they're getting relief on their student loan payments. But you and I, who, you know, make a, you know, whatever you make, $60,000, $50,000. No, you're not getting relief. That's not how this works. So, yeah, eat the rich. Fuck that. Make the rich work in fast food. I'm okay with that. Yeah, let's make the rich work in fast food. That would be funny. That would be. Jesse Waters. Oh my gosh, this is so gross. Okay, so the great debate now, because California has raised their minimum wage to $20 an hour. So basically, if you work fast food in California, you're getting $20 an hour, which is still not a livable fucking wage. It is not a livable wage, especially in California, right? You're not going to be able to rent a house and pay all your bills and have a cushy life like these assholes seem to think. But, you know, Jesse, he's got a problem with it. Jesse, sometimes he gets it right, but most of the time he's just a smug asshole. And this time he's a smug asshole.
If you're making $20 an hour to work at a fast food restaurant, right? Is that six figures? Are you making
$40,000?
40 grand.
Are you making six figures? Oh, shut up.
Okay, so
40K a year.
Okay,
full time.
40K a year. Yeah. So, and then if your husband or wife is also there, you're making $100,000 as a family.
Sure.
Both working at McDonald's.
80 yes. grand.
That's crazy. That is crazy, because that job really doesn't require much. So it's inflating the entire, you know, labor sector.
And the Happy Meal.
Unhappy.
Oh, God.
Which I'm very unhappy about. But
not the Happy Meal. That was just gross. The guy acts like he fucking has a clue, and he doesn't. He's like, what is that, six digits? Like, no. Fuck no, it is not. Not even barely a livable fucking wage. But, you know, they're going to run with this. They're 100% going to run with this, that this is the problem with the economy. They wanted this for a couple of different reasons. And let me tell you what those reasons are. So, one, they can blame a lot of the problems and small businesses that are closing on the fact that, oh, we had to raise the minimum wage. Oh, my gosh. And then it'll make it easier to roll out the AI robotics that we have been seeing for the last couple of years into restaurants. Guess what? Human beings cost fucking money, and robots don't once you pay them off. So this will just be the doorway opening for them to replace those $20 an hour burger flippers with the machine that's going to do it. It all works out in their favor, like always. So he who controls the media controls the masses. Bring back the fairness doctrine. Fuck yeah. And Glass-Steagall. Those are the two things I want for Christmas, okay? I want the fairness doctrine and the Glass-Steagall. Move this. If a high school student flipping burgers deserves $15 an hour, about $2,400 a month, woohoo, then why isn't the minimum social the minimum social security payment? And yeah, I got a big bitch with this one, a big one. You guys know I live in a retirement community, and what we are doing to our seniors is fucking criminal. It's criminal to ask them to feed themselves on $160 a month. It is criminal to give them $980 and expect them to be able to put a roof over their fucking head and turn the power on. It's criminal. They paid in their whole fucking lives, and now we just leave them hanging out there. Where is the cost of living adjustment? They get one every year in January, right? Where they give them an extra $18. But then guess what? The offset they take away from their fucking EBT. So here, you had $160 in food stamps, but we gave you $18 more because of inflation, but we're going to take that $18 out of the food cash that we give you. Even we could just give you enough cash to cover your food, but no, we're going to put you on a supplemental SNAP program. The whole thing is fucking disgusting. It should be illegal. They spend all this money to foreign fucking wars, screw our infrastructure, screw our healthcare, screw our children and their future. And you know what? Screw the elderly too, even though it's their money that got paid in. This one pisses me the fuck off. So yeah, there needs to be a cost of living adjustment immediately. No wait until fucking January. They need to look at the food prices right now and give everybody across the board an EBT raise. They did it under fucking COVID. They gave us an extra $200 a month under COVID. And as soon as fucking inflation hit, they rolled that $200 back. It's insane. It's freaking insanity. You could have money when prices were freaking low, but you can't have money when prices are high. People aren't making it. And then, you know, Trump cut Meals on Wheels the first day in fucking office when he was in office. I'm not a huge Trump fan. You guys know that. I see a lot of difference between Biden and Trump. But really, at the end of the day, they're both fucking evil and they both hurt the working poor. They both hurt the most vulnerable among our communities. And yeah, I would, but I don't have any money. Yeah, that's what our seniors are living with right now. They worked their whole fucking lives to retire and now they are living on, you know, rice and pancakes because that's all you can get from the local food bank. Pisses me off. Let's see. Wrong mouse. Yes, Safeway. I know. Voting third party? We should probably vote third party is what I'm thinking. Check out this video of prices. And I know you guys know because you guys have been to the grocery store. I'm going after the show. I get to go on two shopping trips a month. I go and whatever I can carry back on my person is what I am allowed to eat for the month. And yeah, my shoulders, they kill when I go shopping. So today's not going to be fun. But fortunately, I don't have enough money to weigh myself down with too much to carry home. So check these prices out. Insane.
All right, so let's go shopping in Dillingham, Alaska.
Oh, this is Alaska.
Some donuts. They're only $8. You can get a PB&J.
Those are $2.99, or they used to be.
Go ahead and start out with some $10.59 bread.
$10.59 for a loaf of bread.
For $14.89.
$14.89. I just bought that same thing for $6-something.
Ketchup is a good $18.79. If you like beans or canned goods, they're just only $8.03
for a can of refried beans.
That's great. You got $47 for some steak.
Who can afford that? $47 for some tri-tip?
$26 potatoes. Yep.
$26 for a bag of freaking potatoes that came from the next state down.
When I tell you,
$13 for cranberry?
Juice wouldn't even be allowed at this point.
Yeah, you think?
We will only be drinking water.
Yeah, I gave up orange juice. I've been drinking nothing but water.
You know what? On second hand, we don't need to drink water either. At this point, we can go outside, get a bucket of ice or snow, and we can let it melt.
Hey, Sinead, good to see
you. A bucket of snow water every day at these prices.
Drink a bucket of snow water every day at these prices.
$17 for the cheese.
And that's not even real cheese. We found out most of the cheese in America is not real.
We don't know what chips are anymore. Because
that's just chemicals.
They're just not allowed. $11.29 for a bag of chips.
$11.29.
You can go ahead and get this cute little party tray for $40.99.
$40. Okay. They give me that at the food bank all the time.
The crackers, the cheese, and all that. Oh my goodness.
How much was a pint?
$10.69. Okay, not bad. Not bad.
$18 for a sale. Half a pint.
Go ahead and get a bigger one for $16.59.
Holy shit!
Go ahead and get that ice cream.
Oh, Alaska. All right, I'm sorry. Sale.
Okay.
I guess I'll quit complaining.
For the pie. I like the sales.
Yeah, toilet paper's stupid that's right. price
it's
lately.
A six-pack of toilet paper.
For $20?
You see it. Or you can get the 12 rolls. Mm-hmm. Look at that juice.
That's not even juice. That's just chemicals.
For the regular Hawaiian punch.
$17.99 for Hawaiian punch? I used to pay $1.99 for those all day long.
This is what you're getting right here. Mm-hmm.
That's
$17. Can't even get a cute little pack of juice because that's a good $15.
Holy shit. How much is ramen?
I think the noodles would be like the cheap. Oh, okay. I see the sale. $18.39. Okay. Yeah, can't even get noodles out here.
$18.39 for a pack of top ramen. You guys, we're in trouble. We are seriously in trouble. And I know this is Alaska, but what happens in Alaska ends up happening to the rest of continental United States, I promise you. So, holy crap. I mean, I think our prices are about half of that. I mean, if, you know, $16 for a jug of peanut butter, I think I paid $7 for it the other day, $6 something, so for that same size. But this is insane. Yeah, it's Alaska. Crazy prices. I feel bad for Alaska. I really do. But I'm not that far from Alaska, and I'm paying pretty high prices too. So chances I'll vote for Joe Biden. None. None but in yellow. None but in yellow. He's like a president, but for stupid people. Oh, yeah. That's a good AI for sure. Moving on. Where are we on the deck? Oh, I forget what this is. And I knew when I put it on the deck, I'd forget what it is. But it's got the MSN BC cream of bullshit. So I'm going to assume it's some kind of serious cream of bullshit. Let's check it out.
All right, we're following this breaking news out of Arizona, where the state Supreme Court just made a monumental abortion decision, prospectively enforcing a 159-year-old mandate that is far stricter than the current law that's in place, outright banning abortion at any point by penalty of prison. An abortion rights supporter just summed up what she sees as the impact moments ago.
Oh, this is so good for the Dems. This is so good for the Dems. We can blow my vape out. Okay, you guys know I have been saying this for years now, and a lot of people didn't like that I was saying it, and I did get a lot of pushback that the Dems wanted this. The Dems absolutely want this, and why do they want this? Well, look at who their donors are. So what they're trying to do is not only will they drum up support, right? This is a great battle cry for them, especially with Joe Biden. Oh my God, they're coming for your right for an abortion, right? The thing is they want it thrown back to the states. That's why they didn't fight it. And even Trump admitted it in his speech he gave like 2 days ago, right? Where he was like, oh, the Democrats liked it too. They wanted it thrown out. Let's face it, the Dems could have codified Roe v. Wade for fucking the last 30 goddamn years, and they didn't. They love to campaign on it. It's one of their biggest fucking drumming battle cries. But they wanted it thrown out because they want to make it a travel destination procedure. Meaning that if you live in Arizona, you can probably go to Nevada and the Democrats, the blue state, is going to pay your way to go have the procedure done that you need to have. And they're going to put you up in a hotel and everything will be compensated and paid for. That is what's coming. And the Democrats know it. And who does that benefit? That benefits the big Planned Parenthood clinics that are going to be in the blue states that are going to get all that funding and all that money to have those there. So yeah, it won't be available in some red states. I've always believed in a woman's right to choose, abso-frickin-lutely, but that's not what's being attacked here. It's such a different thing. It's such a different animal when you understand that both sides of the fucking unibird want this. They do, for multiple different reasons, right? So the Dems got their battle cry. They're going to be beating this one hard. When I saw it yesterday, I was like, oh, shit. Great. That's going to be the main issue now, that I'm going to have to fight with 65-year-old little ladies who were brainwashed into the hippie movement. And we'll get there. oh, my God, they're coming for your rights. And, yep, that's exactly what we're seeing. I brought you an example of it. This is Fox News, of course. They had to get out there. Trump's Israel losing the PR war.
Thank you for mentioning it. The historic fundraiser last night, President Trump hauling in more than $50 million. As you noted, it is a historic fundraiser, the most ever for a single fundraising event in political history. Double what Biden, Obama, and Clinton took in New York City last week. Our team is well-equipped, well-funded, well-organized to secure victory for Donald Trump and Republicans up and down the ballot on November the 5th.
Can we move on to the question?
And that is why. Yes, and that's why the Democrats are taking his words out of context.
Oh, the Democrats are taking his words out of context. So, yes, Trump had the biggest fundraiser in the histories of fundraisers. And I'm sure he's going to go out there and tell you about it because Trump loves to tell you when he does something big, right? Yeah, this is just going to get worse. This is going to get so much worse. Hang on. It's going to be a wild ride till November. CNN, the corrupt news, the best lies money can buy. Yeah, they are the best lies money can buy. But Fox is right there with them. We know that. Absolutely. Okay, so they had Harris. Those two got split. They shouldn't have been split. They had Harris do the rebuttal and reaction to the Supreme Court's ruling on abortion yesterday. So I thought I'd bring it for you. Let's hear what the Democrats have to say about what is going on in Arizona.
Today, the Arizona Supreme Court issued a ruling that creates a near total abortion ban in the state of Arizona, a ban with no exceptions for rape and incest, a ban that will apply to women before they even know they are pregnant, and threatens prison time for nurses and doctors. And all of this by reviving a law that was passed in the 1800s, before women could vote, and before Arizona was even a state. Understand, to stop bans like this, we need a United States Congress that will restore the protections of Roe v. Wade. And when they do, President Joe Biden will sign it into
law. No, he fucking won't!
And let's always remember, it does not have to be this way.
Oh my God. It is this way because the Democrats refuse to follow through with every campaign promise that they've made in my fucking lifetime. In my lifetime. You know, my mother was a flower child hippie of the 60s and 70s. And she was all about women's lib and, you know, a woman's right to choose. And in her final days, she really had a turnaround when she understood that she had been lied to about so many things. So many things have been co-opted in our lifetime that we didn't even know our whole entire life. Go back and look at where Planned Parenthood came from. Now, I'm not stepping on anybody's right to choose, but I am telling you that is an evil entity that is there to make fucking money. I've crossed the abortion picket line with, and you guys know this, I've told you guys my stories of taking one of my daughters and having to deal with that shit. And the things that they did were insane. Like taking pictures of the fetus and showing it to my 13-year-old daughter and telling her to make a decision, you know, to either end this or keep your baby. Why are you messing with the 13-year-old's fucking head who's already fucked up enough? There's just a lot of fucking problems with Planned Parenthood, and I used to blindly follow and support. I could pull out a box now of a shit ton of Planned Parenthood pins and, you know, banners and ribbons and signs. I used to go up there and fight back against the Republicans all the damn time. I don't do that anymore because we're being sold a fucking lie, and we beg these guys to protect the lie that they've sold us over the years. And thank you, Bad Cookie. Bad Cookie says, God, Shanda, you really reached me with your Social Security rant. We need to take care of our elderly, and we are giving them a death sentence. Oh yeah, throw Big Pharma on top of it, definitely a death sentence. Here, we'll feed you this garbage and Rockefeller medicine. That's what it comes down to at the end of the day. Okay, so this one cracked me up. This next two stories. Oh my God, this is so funny. Okay, so on May 31st of 2023, President Trump announced that the United States will be celebrating a return of the World's Fair in 3 years that left the planet speechless in 1890. Okay, do you guys remember the Chicago's World Fair in 1890? It was the 400, or it was, what was it? It was the 400th anniversary of Columbus landing in America, and that's why they had the Chicago's World Fair, right? And they built all these fucking amazing, insane buildings on like 700 acres of land in Chicago, and they showed the world all the technology of the world, right? Lights and stuff, because, you know, this was the 1890s, so light bulbs were a big thing. And then they tore it all down. Like a year later, the whole thing was gone. All of these magnificent fucking buildings that could be standing to this day. It's insane. Go Google it. But anyways, Trump says this will be similar to the New York Fair in 1939, the Chicago Fair in 1893, and the Nashville World Fair of 1897. Nashville had a World Fair in 1987. I'll have to look that up. I don't even know. There are even claims of free energy technology utilizing Tesla towers during those fairs. Yeah, because they stole it, and we've had free energy for all those years. They just don't want us to have it, and we all know that, right? Anyways, Trump's going to throw the biggest party ever. Let's hear about it.
3 years from now, the United States will celebrate the biggest and most important milestone in our country's history. 250 years of American independence. What a great country. We have to keep it that way. But that's why, okay, as a nation, we should be preparing for a most spectacular birthday party. We want to make it the best of all time. Here's my plan to give America's founding in 1776 the incredible anniversary it truly deserves.
Look at those buildings. They tore those down.
I will convene a White House task force called Salute to America 250. It will be responsible for coordinating with state and local governments to ensure not just one day of celebration, but an entire year of festivities.
We get to party for a year.
Nation starting on Memorial Day 2025 and continuing through July 4th.
I gotta live to 2025.
Second, I will work with all 50 governors, Republican and Democrat alike, to create the Great American State Fair, a unique one-year exhibition featuring pavilions from more than 50 states. It'll be something. The Great American State Fair will showcase the glory of every state in the Union, promote pride in our history, and put forth innovative visions for America's future. My hope is that
even
the amazing people of Iowa will work
with those buildings they tore down
to open up the legendary Iowa State Fairgrounds to host the
Great American State Fair
and welcome millions and millions of visitors from around the world.
I lived in Iowa.
To the heartland of America for this special one time.
Lucifer, what are you doing there?
Together we will build it and they will come. Third, alongside the Great American State Fair, we will host.
Look at that building! They tore that down a year later.
Athletes. These are great athletes, wonderful athletes from fantastic high schools
all
around
the
country.
Yeah.
These Patriot Games will allow young Americans from every state
God,
to show
we're
off
do
best
like
of
Patriot
American
Games.
Skills, sportsmanship, and competitive spirit. Fourth, I will sign an executive order to bring back our National Garden of American Heroes, which we want to build very badly. Commission artists for the first 100 statues to populate this new statuary park honoring the greatest Americans.
Oh, we're
going to
get a
time.
Statue park.
Fifth, as president,
we already have
I will
Madame
invite
Tussauds.
The leaders and citizens of nations around the world.
Oh, we're
going to
do the infamous
the
infant incubators again.
50th anniversary. It's going to be great. America's tourist industry should get ready because we're going to have a lot of people coming. It will be a record year. And finally, and most importantly, I will ask America's great religious communities to pray for our nation and our people as we prepare for this momentous occasion.
Oh, God.
From the very beginning, America has been a country sustained and strengthened.
I don't know how much more of this I can take. Shut up, Trump.
and by our communities of faith. As we chart a course toward the next 250 years, let us come together and rededicate ourselves as one nation under God. Thank you.
Oh, he didn't say indivisible. Okay, that's just like, I'm like, what the fuck? Who's thinking about a party 2.5 years from now? Apparently Trump is. He's going to throw down and make P. Diddy look like Pee Wee Herman because he's going to party for a year. I'm like, oh, Trump wants to outdo P. Diddy in his partying. What do you guys think? I haven't heard Joe Biden's plans for this big party anniversary, the 250th, right? I definitely want to make sure I'm alive till 2025 to see this shit. Why is it going to be in Iowa, though? Seriously? Iowa? I lived in Iowa for a while when I was 18, and I just got to say, I really wasn't. Anyways, woke influencer list of terrifying things that Trump will do if he wins, accidentally makes the most epic campaign ad ever. As this influencer lists all the different things, just yes or no. Do you support Trump doing this or not? So here we go.
And here are the first 15 promises he has made if he is reelected. You may have heard of Project 2025, but this is from Agenda 47. And you can read all of these on his website. First, he promises that he will carry out the largest domestic deportation operation in history. He will also ask for the death sentence for anyone convicted of human trafficking. He will close the Department
kind
of Education and return all education standards to the states to decide. He will put prayer back into school and he will criminalize any race-based advantage programs. He will end the Affordable Care Act. He will ban gender-affirming care for adults and children, and he will ban any federal dollars from going towards gender-affirming care.
Let's take care of people's health,
which means anyone with
government-provided
health care will no longer be able to access gender-affirming care except for Viagra and Cialis. Those will still be available. He will propose a constitutional amendment that gives a term limit to Congress.
I'm okay with that.
He will deploy the Department of Justice to investigate the Biden crime family and any of his adversaries or political rivals. He will immediately pardon all of the January 6thers, and he will create a task force to investigate anyone who arrested, charged, or imprisoned a January 6th. He will increase the penalties for underage criminal offenders, strengthen immunity for police officers, and deploy the National Guard to patrol woke cities. On day one, he will reassess our participation in NATO and says that every European country needs to pay the United States for protection.
He won't kick
us out of
NATO. He
will also restore the wonderful travel ban for Muslims coming to America. He will build freedom cities. This is 10 new cities built on federal land. He will award them to areas with the best development proposals, and he will prioritize moving young families to these freedom cities. He will kill all e-vehicles and e-vehicle legislation, seeking to replace that with the development of a flying car. He believes that we could create a car that vertically takes off. He will remove all of the limits on American natural gas exports and drill, baby, drill for oil domestically.
Oh, because Obama
did. He will impose a tariff of up to 60% on Chinese imports. He will extend
as well
the 2017
as
tax cuts and drop the corporate tax rate from 21% to 15%. He will push Congress to pass legislation that would give every American the right to concealed carry anywhere at any time.
And
he will revoke
let's do this.
Any gun restrictions or legislation that seeks to inhibit people's ability to own guns that's been passed in the last several years. He will demand that Europe pay back all the money we gave Ukraine, and then he will use all of that money to recruit for the American military.
Yeah.
And he will take billions and billions of dollars from private university endowments by taxing, fining, and suing the universities. He specifically names Harvard in this one. And then he will use that money to create the American Academy. It is a free online college that will be free of wokeness that he will force employers to recognize as a bachelor's degree equivalent. So that's Agenda 47.
Oh, come on. None of this shit is actually going to happen. And I don't, DC, I don't think that tariffs are a bad thing. I absolutely don't. That's how a U.S. makes money. That's how we compete. I think that not having tariffs for a long time is really what's fucked us up for a long time. But I don't pretend to understand the economy, right? Did you guys see this gross shit? So how does Peterson control his ventriloquist dummy without sticking his hand up his ass? Yeah, these two right here. You know, when it comes down to it, think about both of these. Oh, my God, so far right. But are they that far right? They have the same exact stance as Hillary Clinton when it comes to Israel. There's not that much difference. I just don't see the difference. And so, for fuck's sakes, who let the gate open on the fucktard farm? Yeah, I don't know. But they're here. They're here. And they're not that far different from the... There is the middle. These guys are the middle. That's what I see. They're the middle. And we pretend that there's a difference. Come on. Register. Thank you. Here we go. Oh, JFK Jr. Yeah. I had to bring you this one because he's out there telling you stuff you want to hear too. No, not Biden and his bullshit and Trump and his bullshit. Well, let's hear what RFK Jr. is promising you. Let's see. He's going to free Snowden. But he doesn't say a goddamn word about Assange that I remember. Let's see. Does he say something about Assange? I don't think he says anything about Assange. He just says he's going to pardon Snowden. Which, hey, I'm cool with that. But I don't see RFK Jr. getting that close. Oh, and then his running mate, you know, what's her name? Shoshana. Anyways, she came out with a picture of her holding her baby, talking out both sides of her face, saying, I support abortion, but I don't support abortion. So that's where we are. Hold on. There we go.
I'm going to pardon Edward Snowden on my first day in office as president. Edward Snowden performed a critical public service by revealing to Americans for the first time that our government had been spying on millions of us, of law-abiding American citizens, in violation of numerous laws and of our fundamental right to privacy. To intensify the spotlight on his case and bring pressure to bear on the Biden administration, I'm asking now that you sign a petition calling for the president to immediately pardon Edward Snowden and allow him to return unfettered to the United States.
Now, what would you do about Snowden?
I think he's a total traitor. And I would deal with him harshly.
No, I don't think Mr. Snowden was a patriot.
Do you think he's a traitor?
I know he damaged the country. The Obama administration will deal with it.
Prior to Edward Snowden, nobody knew that the intelligence agencies were illegally mining all of our data and spying on American citizens. So it's not surprising that those same intelligence agencies.
Did he just say China bad? I think he just said China bad.
And that captive politicians are supporting that narrative. In fact, Edward Snowden is an American hero. Instead of jailing Snowden, I'm going to build a statue to him and maybe to Julian Assange somewhere near the
Washington Press Club. Oh, he does bring up Assange.
Outside the CIA headquarters in Langley.
Put it right on the CIA's headquarters.
It's time that we return our government to the democratic and humanitarian ideals that we've always represented as a nation.
Bill Binney! Bill Binney made it!
Free speech and celebrating truth tellers and the whistleblowers who put their careers and their own freedom on the line to protect ours. Please sign our petition and help me send a message to Washington, D.C. that the American people are fed up with the unjust treatment of Edward Snowden.
God, if only RFK Jr. wasn't a smooly dildo, he might actually be worth voting, because when he does get it right, he gets it right. I mean, I still get my Children's Health Defense email every morning, and I absolutely agree with the things he's fighting for. I absolutely agree with this. It's the fucking problem is his apex support over here that I cannot get behind. I get emails every day from, you know, people who have followed my work for years that are like, Chanda, why are you not on board with RFK Jr.? Because he supports genocide. That is why. Yeah, I can get on board with a lot of things he's saying. I love how China bad. And, you know, DC, that really talks to the fact that, I mean, for one, we will never have a say over, you know, tariffs either way. But they really, you know, you had the Clinton administration who fucking sold us out to China 100% They'd been selling us out to China for a long time, all the way back to Nixon. Thank you to Mr. Evil himself. But the fact of the matter is they want to villainize China. They don't want us getting things from China. But the problem is we don't fucking manufacture anything here at home anymore. So what happens if we go to war with China over Taiwan? Do you think that we're going to be getting shipments out of China of our cheap flip-flops and all the shit we buy at the dollar store? No. So it's not, I think that the whole tariff point is moot anyways. When it comes down to both sides of the Uniparty, they want this. They're both anti-CCP. Think about it. Pelosi's always out there saying it. The Republicans are always out there saying it. Oh, China bad, China bad. And even Trump loves to say China's bad. So yeah, they'll get their war. You'll get your war one way or another. Oregon, this is gross. Oregon's using satellite technology to locate small farms defined as anyone producing eggs, milk, meat, or that has goats, sheep, or horses, regardless of size, and is shutting them down. Yeah, we're seeing a lot of crazy shit in Oregon because they're stealing all the water rights from all the farmers, right? And I think that's just the first state they're rolling that out in. I think we're going to see it in a lot more states. And yeah, we have no privacy. We have no privacy. There is a million different things pointing at you right now that knows exactly where you are, what you have, you know, what you're using, whether it be satellites, whether it be the router that they're bouncing off in your house, whether it be your cell phone, whether it be your computer camera. They're looking at you in a million different ways, or they can just do it by your data. So there is no hiding. There is going to be no privacy. Remember, Klaus told us. You won't have privacy. And if you have nothing to hide, like your eggs and milk, then you'll be okay. I'm not surprised by this. We've known this was coming. 100%. Norfolk Southern agrees to pay $600 million for the East Palestina, Ohio train derailment. I think that's going to cover all the health care for the whole entire town that just got poisoned. Probably not, but you know, they got their slap on the wrist and everything will be fine. It's just like with Big Pharma. You know, Pfizer lies, they do deceptive practices, and they get a little slap on the wrist and they continue to move on, just like Norfolk Southern will. Sad that they're allowed to poison us and they don't even have to pay. Hey, check out this smart meter right here. Look at that. You see the smart meter? Look at the side of the tree. Look at that tree. That's crazy. But no, it's not harmful to you. That's all in your head. Quit being a conspiracy theorist. That is so bad. So bad. Imagine what it's doing to your brain. Oh, so this is Paris. Yeah, this is Paris Disneyland. Check this out. chemtrails are not real. Geoengineering's all in your head. That's totally normal. Normal. Those are just planes. A lot of planes flying over Paris. Yeah, those were contrails. Those were not chemtrails. What the hell? We're supposed to believe that that's normal. And a huge portion of the population will stand there toe-to-toe with you, look you in the eye, and tell you you're crazy that that is normal. That has always been like that. That's what planes do. Blows my mind every day. Blows my mind. My own brother. I have gone rounds with my brother about chemtrails. Oh my God. Shanda, you know better. You were raised smarter than that. You know that that is not chemicals being dumped on us. That's just the condensation coming out of the back of the plane. Like, ugh. You need to read a million articles and go watch the testimony that was given to our Congress many years ago, baby bro. Anyways, Blaze Media, scientists just tested and fired a cloud device over American soil with the ultimate aim of blocking out the sun. Now, we talked about this the other day. This was the, basalts for the sky. That's what I'm calling it. Basalts for the sky. No, I've got this article. Let's bring this in. Okay. Oh, that was so smooth. Do you guys see that? Oh my gosh. I don't have to bring in an extra window. I can literally just go to the next tab. Okay. So the U.S. Hornet may be decommissioned aircraft carrier, yet it has nevertheless became the launching site for a controversial new war in the skies. Yes, that's right. The Marine Cloud Brightening Program. Oh, such a nice name, right? The coastal atmospheric aerosol research and engagement project led by research at the University of Washington. Oh, University of Washington, always leading the charge out here for chemtrails. Took to the deck of the Hornet Tuesday to launch a stream of particles into the sky above San Francisco Bay. The ultimate objective is apparently to block out the reflections of sunlight in hopes of limiting global warming. Now, why didn't they make a big deal out of this? Because they didn't want a lot of pushback. They even say that in this article. So let's see. Open letter that reduced the risk of solar geoengineering are poorly understood and can never be fully known. Impacts various across regions, uncertain about the effects on the weather pattern, agricultural, and provisions of basic needs of food and water. They don't know. This is the experiment. So cloud bounces some of the sun rays back into space, and supposedly that helps cool the atmosphere. So they're saying that, hey, if a volcano erupts and it blocks the sun out, it cools us down. So that works. We're going to do the same thing, basically. So the University of Washington Department of Sciences conceded that fossil fuel emissions and other human activities have long generated aerosols in the atmosphere that mix in a low altitude cloud, causing them to brighten and reflect more sunlight, having a cooling effect on Earth's climate. I think most people are aware that there are greenhouse gases affecting the warming climate. Oh, yes, yes, we know about that. Says the Weather Channel. We're supposed to believe the Weather Channel, owned by CNN, right? Is that who owns the Weather Channel? I think Turner Network owned that, right? I want to get to the part where they said the reason they didn't tell us the concerns every year there's been record blah blah blah. In addition, solar modifying, nothing good there. Yeah. Last month, a group of 31 top scientists noted that in a paper published in the Science Advance, there was a lack of clear understanding of the relationship between aerosols and the meteorological conditions and liquid water and cloud fraction adjustments and their timescaler. Oh, yeah. They don't know, but they're just going to try it out because, hey, you never know. And the White House told the Times in a statement, the U.S. government is not involved in the solar radiation modification, the SRM, experiment taking place in California. So government goes, we have nothing to do with it, man. We don't know. We didn't do it. We don't know. This is so gross. I love when they said the reason they didn't tell us is because we'd freak out. Well, we didn't tell you guys because you guys would freak out and think we're doing terrible shit. We're not, even though we are, right? Kurt's here. Good to see you, Kurt Voss. Good to see you. Mastermind's hanging out still. So is Jilly and Bad Cookie and DC. Yeah. Oh, we're going to talk MK Ultra, DC. I got some MK Ultra stuff. I fell down a fucking rabbit hole that I've been in before, but we'll get there. It's in Hollyweird. Elon Musk, we need to get our employees in Brazil to a safe place or otherwise not in a position of responsibility. They will do a full data dump. They have been told that they will be arrested. Okay, so Brazil has decided to go after Elon Musk. And they are building a case against him. And so that's what he is crying about, getting his ex-workers out of Brazil. And yeah, they decided they're going to go after him for spreading disinformation, I think. And truth, it is the new hate speech during a time of universal deficit. Telling the truth becomes a revolutionary act. Yes, we do know that. We do. Come on. Wrong. Did I get the wrong mouse again? Maybe. So weird, because the mouse screen is over here, but I'm staring over here to make the mouse work. So bear with me. I thought this was interesting. So this is a composite of all of Elon's phallics that he has blasted into space. Want to check it out? I just thought you guys would like it. Hold on. Here we go. April 2010. Every time he blows his load. So does every one of those represent a satellite that went into the sky? That's what I'm thinking. I mean, okay, so if only half of those were sending up satellites, that's a lot of goddamn satellites that are above us right now. And we know that. If you're paying attention to the star map, any of you guys have that app on your phone, I have it for the grandkids. They fucking love it. But you can see all the satellites that are up there. There's literally rings and rings of satellites. I don't know how they're going to get to the moon or to Mars without hitting one of those damn things, right? Yeah, we know you're a huge asshole. You don't have to tell us. We're very aware. And next slide is, oh, NASA. Let's talk NASA for a while. Did you guys know there's a new movie coming out this summer with Woody Harrelson? Yeah, there is. And it's pretty much a soft disclosure that we didn't go to the moon. Yeah, go look at it. It's called Fly Me to the Moon. It's called Fly Me to the Moon, and it's got Woody Harrelson and Scarlett Johansson, and it's going to drop sometime this summer. And basically, it's how they hired a PR firm like Mad Men to come in and sell NASA to the American public during the 60s. We've been saying this for a long effing time. Remember, now, we've all seen this clip. Remember when NASA told us that they lost all the technology to go to the moon? Yeah, let's hear it again, just for good times.
In a nanosecond. The problem is we don't have the technology to do that anymore. We used to, but we destroyed that technology, and it's a painful process to build it back
again. We destroyed it. Why did we destroy that technology? And why is it a painful process to build it back again? I don't understand. I don't understand. But okay, moving on. We got a couple of different clips in here that are mind-blowing. Okay, so you guys have seen this. I know you've seen this Stanley Kubrick interview, right? It's not real from what we're being told. And I remember this was on YouTube for a long time. And maybe it's likened to the George Orwell. Remember, there's a clip out there where it's supposed to be George Orwell and he's in a bed and he's talking, imagine a boot on your neck, you know, that. And that wasn't a real. That was filmed a long time after he died. So this very well could be it, because Reuters, you know, Reuters fact check, they always tell us the truth. They say this is just an actor playing Stanley Kubrick, and that's he never told anybody that he filmed the moon landing. That's not what his daughter says. Have you ever seen his daughter? She's freaking cuckoo, but she does say a lot of stuff. So let's check this old clip out.
A huge fraud, which I am now about to detail.
Okay.
Involving the United States government and NASA.
All right.
And I'm sure you've heard the rumors.
The moon landing? Hoax?
That's right. That the moon landing was fake. The moon landings all were fake. And I was the person who filmed it.
You're serious? And okay.
I'm serious. I'm dead serious.
Why are you telling me? I'm a nobody. Like,
the moon landings were fake.
Okay, and I want to hear what the hell you're saying. I don't know. Tell me how, what, when, where. I'd like to hear the story about this, but why are you telling me? And is that, so that's the 15-year thing. So that makes sense now. That's why I can't release this for 15 years. That makes total sense now.
Yes.
Okay.
Of course, stress, guilt, just conflict of all kinds.
And my upcoming film, Eyes Wide Shut, is all about secrecy. It takes place in the sexual underground, but it's really about secrecy.
Okay, we didn't land on the moon, you're saying, and you filmed.
No, we didn't land on the moon.
Okay, so I was born in 71.
Nobody landed.
I was born in 71. I didn't see that stuff anyway. So just how about you walk me through it? If you have, just indulge me.
Yeah, I don't believe this is Kubrick either.
Or as quickly as we can. How did something like this start? Did someone just apply to an ad to film the moon landings?
No,
like
I was contacted by NASA.
Okay, when, where, why? I mean, what happened?
He doesn't know when.
Sometime
in the 60s.
Before I started making 2001, so in the mid-60s sometime.
I'll let it finish playing. You guys can hear what it says.
Well, considerably after then, yeah. And they had seen Dr. Strangelove, and I had originally requested use of the B-52 to film part of Dr. Strangelove, and they refused, but they were very impressed by the...
Okay, so I do believe this story, but this is not Kubrick. And I think that this was like one of those, what do they call it, a spoof documentary type of thing where, and then the person said that, oh, I actually got this interview 15 years ago and he told me I couldn't release it. I had to sit on it for 15 years. I don't know. But, you know, I follow his daughter. I can't remember her name right now, but she has came out and said a lot of crazy shit about her dad. And I think that she did some weird shit about supporting Biden, maybe in 2016. I don't know. There was something that turned me off about her. I don't remember what it is. So, that's not real. Let's check this out, though. This is WikiLeaks releases moon landing cut scenes filmed in Nevada desert. Let's see.
Well, this is a hell of a time not to.
That's right.
We're in a little deep now. Right. Let me tell you.
Thank you, Jilly, for dropping that link.
Marker?
Practice makes perfect. How the Apollo 11 crew prepared
right
for
now,
the launch.
Jim, that was better.
So NASA admits that this video is real, but they say it was a practice run that they ran in the desert. That they weren't filming the moon landing, that they were just practicing. Come on, that thing landed on the moon. Come on, no. Why is that gonna be so damn loud? I don't know if WikiLeaks actually dropped this. I cannot confirm that. I mean, it has a WikiLeaks logo on it, but that don't mean crap.
Oh,
it's like, is it over?
The beauty of this place is just absolutely incredible. there's another spectacular view. The pilot who missed the crater.
So this is in Arizona. This is not on the moon. Or no, this is Nevada. Sorry, Nevada.
And action.
And action.
I think that's awfully good.
So I think they're in the pool. You know, how they do the underwater training. I think they're filming a lot of this in the pool. Oh, cut. This explains a lot, though. It does explain a lot. Like the shadows, for sure. I don't know. Let me know. What do you guys think? Did we land on the moon in 69? Do you really think we landed on the moon in 69? And check out that link that Jilly just dropped to Fly Me to the Moon. That is the new movie that's coming out this summer, which is going to be a soft disclosure of the fact that it was a PR campaign and we had to beat Russia. So that's why we went to the moon. But NASA's going to tell you, nay. This video may have been filmed on the ground, but it was just for training purposes and training purposes only. This cracked me up yesterday. So Congresswoman Sheila Jackson, a Democrat, Sheila Jackson Lee, the moon is made up mostly of gases. Yes, these are the people that are ruling your country. Check it out.
And sometimes you've heard the word full moon. Sometimes you need to take the opportunity just to come out and see a full moon is that complete rounded circle, which is made up mostly of gases. And that's why the question is why or how could we as humans live on the moon? Are the gases such that we could do that? The sun is a mighty powerful heat. It's almost impossible to go near the sun.
Not quite.
The moon is more manageable.
Yeah,
you will see in a moment, or not a moment, you'll see in a couple of years that NASA is going back to the moon.
She must have attended the Kamala Harris School of Thought, I'm assuming, right? Because the sun is almost untouchable. Like, this is the funniest shit. The moon is made up mostly of gases when it's full. These are the people ruling our country. Oh my God, too fucking stupid. The sun is gas and the moon is a rock, right? No, but she said the moon is gas. So, yeah, Alzheimer's, no. I think that it's just who they are, man. That's just who they are. I love NASA. Blocked. Yes, please block them. Block them if they love NASA. And, take me away from here. I miss the days when they used to be afraid of us. Yeah, we're not afraid. We're begging for you to get us the hell off of this crazy planet for sure. Too funny. But I just thought that was crazy because, you know, NASA, because they are dropping a movie this summer. And we know that no movie gets made in Hollywood without all of the secret agencies signing off on that shit. The Department of Defense, the CIA, it doesn't matter. They're all involved in these movies. So obviously they know enough of us know the truth that they've got to come out and spin it somehow. And that's what this movie is going to be. How much you want to bet this movie is a spin saying that, yeah, we did do a lot of filming out in the desert. And yeah, we did a bunch of PR stuff. But hey, we actually made it to the moon. We made it to the moon. That's the way this movie's going to end. I'm telling you, they're going to end it on the moon. I promise. Oh, more stupid stuff. Okay. Yeah. We got Sunny from the Poo. Well, let's hear what she has to say. And what the fuck? Yeah, we are in what the fuck. We made it to the what the fuck section because it is Wednesday. You got to have Wednesday's what the fuck. Here we go.
Leaving, we've got a solar eclipse. We've got
the
earthquake.
She
ran down the hallway.
The rapture is here.
The rapture's here. And then also, I learned that the cicadas are coming.
Cicadas. The cicadas.
Although I love the first time in
cicadas,
like
cicada.
No,
100 years.
No.
Two That's, different.
No,
two,
no.
Well, this is what I read. Two different
there's
times.
There's two different kinds of cicadas.
Yes, two different
coming.
Times.
Oh God, Whoopi would know.
But for the first time in many, many years.
No, every 17 years this happens.
Well, that's not what I read, but maybe. But, you know,
I know everything because I read.
But
in a way,
say all those things together
would maybe lead one to believe that, you know, either climate change exists.
That's more
or something.
Oh my God. What does cicadas have to do with climate change?
It's underground. No.
It happens.
Climate change doesn't happen underground.
We've known about the eclipse coming because eclipses happen.
Oh my God, these are the stupidest people on the fucking planet. Are you kidding me? They are arguing about cicadas being a part of climate change and global warming. Enough. Enough stupid shit. What the fuck? Let's see. Wrong mouse again. Here we go. I ate cricket mincemeat and it was delicious. Here's why we should all be eating insects. And I have a feeling a lot more of us are eating insects than you even know. Like I got one of these the other day. And let's see. It's a brisk, right? Well, it turns out that they are actually using crickets in order to color these now. So I think that they're sneaking it into all of our foods. A lot of the, you know, prepackaged shit that we buy, it's in there. You just don't even know it. So yeah, that's kind of gross. That is kind of gross if you ask me. And oh, this one broke this morning. Did you get your Legible? Yeah. Lunchables are apparently filled with so much fucking lead that it's off the chart, like in the 70 percentile for a fucking Lunchable. There's only like three crackers and three meats in those things. What? So Consumer Reports found high levels of lead, cadmium, and sodium in Lunchables. Well, yeah, obviously sodiums and everything. The popular kid snack may pose a risk to kidneys, skeletal, and respiratory health, with reported lead levels unsafe for children. Kraft, we reduce sodium in the crackers by 26%. We are proud of Lunchables and stand by the quality and integrity. The USDA is under pressure as a petition calls for removing Lunchables from the National School Lunch Program. Oh, fuck me. They're in the school lunch program? What? USDA schools balance higher sodium products than lower sodium idols on the day. So the source is the Hill, and the Hill is saying, look at the sodium levels. Don't look at the 73% lead levels because we don't even track that. It's safe. It's above, it's below the allowed limit, so it's okay. I cannot believe this is the shit that is targeted to our children, and it's approved in the National School Lunch Program. Who did that shit? Michelle Obama? Probably would be my guess. Lunchables bad, guys. Stop eating Lunchables. And don't buy the Hillshire Farm ones either, because then you're supporting genocide. You can't win. Can't win no matter what you do, what you eat in America. You're just eating poison. I just thought this was weird and creepy. If all 8 billion human beings were ground into mincemeat, the resulting ball of flesh would be just under 1 kilometer in diameter meters, in diameters. Oh my God. Meat wad. Meat wad. What are you doing? Why would anybody even think this shit up? Like, oh, if we ground up every person on the planet, I think that's what they're doing in Gaza, right? I'm pretty sure it is. Oz gave us this one. Let's see. What is this? So Northrop Grumman completes the Manta Ray underwater drone prototype. Oh, yippee. National Harbor says Northrop Grumman said it finished building its prototype of the Manta Ray underwater drone, devised for assignments that demand longer hours and extended range under minimizing human involvement. Ah, so they've got a underwater drone now that can go for hours. Yay. Let's see. Reward them for the world that they've created. I think we should. What do you think? Should we reward them? I think we should reward them. You know, I used to take a lot of shit for putting the chippy choppies on my deck, and I don't care because that's the only way we're going to fix this shit. And you and I both know it. This is a crazy story right here. Yeah, wackos everywhere. A plague of madness. That's what we're living through. So a 25-year-old woman shares her unique love story, revealing that she has married a 6-foot Halloween doll and is in a polyamorous relationship with it and her zombie doll wife together. They're expecting their 11th child. Aw, isn't that sweet?
Felicity Cadillac, take Robert Cadillac to be your husband, your spiritual partner, and love him unconsciously through thick and thin.
If it moves, I'm going to freak out.
Felicity Cadillac, take Robert Cadillac to be my
she
husband
looks at
to
it.
Have and to hold from this day forward.
Oh my God. gosh, the world is broken. That is creepy and crazy. I mean, if that thing moved, I was going to freak out. But she looks at it like she meant her vows for sure. You know, live and let live, I guess. Whatever. Do each their own. Kind of crazy. I wonder what their kids are going to look like, though, right? Yeah. Do they look like Freddy? Do they look like Jason? I don't know. It's a 6-foot Halloween doll. I bet you they honeymooned at the Spirit of Halloween. That would be my guess. Anyways, so stupid. Hollywood, go F yourself. Let's see what we got in here. Did you guys see there's a new Clockwork Orange? Why do they got to ruin everything? Why? Why? Why do you have to remake Clockwork Orange with Tom Holland? You don't need to. We have the original. It was just fine. Just like every other remake you're pulling for this summer. I have a prediction. We're going to see more remakes this summer than we have in our entire fucking lives. And that is because Hollywood has no original fucking ideas. And they don't even have any writers anymore because they're letting AI do it all. So this is what we're cursed with. Yeah, because there's no original left in Hollywood. Yeah, Bad Cookie. I agree. There is. They have no original ideas anymore. Oh, so this is the rabbit hole I fell down, and I've been down this rabbit hole before, so let me tell you about this. So, weird scenes inside the canyon. If you want to know where the hippie movement came from, don't look at Haight-Ashbury. Go look at Laurel Canyon, because that's where it came from, and every one of those fuckers had some kind of connection to the government. I don't care if it was Frank Zappa, Jim Morrison, didn't matter. They all grew up in a government MKUltra fucking mind control. And guess what came from them? The hippie movement. That's right. So let's see. Inside, did I actually put a cut on this? Let me see if I actually cut this. How do I do that? Go this way. Nope. Do I have another slide deck? Damn it, I thought I had another slide deck open. I have too many screens. I'm so confused. Too many. Anyways, I guess we'll pull the trigger and see if I put a cut on this. If not, go find this. All you got to do is type in, it's like a 2-hour podcast. David McGovern wrote this book, but there's a lot of good interviews with him. I want to say David McGovern had passed on since writing this, but he wrote a couple of good books. And there's so much information about the Laurel Canyon covert ops and the dark heart of the hippie dream. It will melt your mind down. I mean, my mom had me when she was 16 years old. My mother was an absolute product of the hippie movement. In 74, she was 16 years old. So she had came up in, you know, 68. Well, she came home from Guam in 68. So although, you know, 5 years, I remember when I was 4 years old, us going to San Francisco and meeting up in Haight-Ashbury. I mean, two of my uncles were bikers. It was like something straight out of Easy Rider. That was my childhood. That's what I knew. You know, I grew up with Burn Your Bra and Gloria Steinem, and they were sold that movement and they bought it hook, line, and fucking sinker. And now I go back and look at the origins of that movement, and it's mind melting to me. And I can see the parallels in how it controlled my mother's thinking and who she became at the core, who she was, because of the things that were being sold to her by these influencers that came out in the late 60s and early 70s. So I'm going to pull this and see if I actually have a cut on something. Oh, I do.
The first CIA program was known as MKUltra. The MK is an abbreviation for the German words for mind control. By 1953, the CIA, U.S. Navy, and U.S. Army Chemical Corps were conducting their own narco-hypnosis programs on prisoners, mental patients, foreigners, ethnic minorities, and those classified as sexual deviants. To avoid confusion, the dozens of mind control operations will be referred to generically as MKUltra. According to MKUltra documents and sources, the methodology of mind control works best when severe trauma is administered by the age of 3 years old.
We'll be right back.
Sally Field.
SCI also sponsored a course at the University of South Carolina in rituals of demonology and voodoo. Dr. Aldrich was
Satanists.
An MKUltra programmer who focused on remote brain manipulation and the occult, the twin threads that run through SCI.
Aw, Taylor Swift's daddy!
In 1962, a CIA manual focused on radio-hypnotic intracerebral control, RHIC, which was developed by the Pentagon, quote, when a part of your brain receives a tiny electrical impulse from outside sources, such as vision, hearing, etc., an emotion is produced, anger at the sight of a gang of boys beating an old woman, for example. The same emotions of anger can be created by artificial radio signals sent to your brain by a controller. You could instantly feel the same white-hot anger without any apparent reason, unquote.
Oh, I remember that. DC Snipers, right? So, okay, that was just a small taste of this rabbit hole. I've been down this rabbit hole many fucking times, and you're absolutely right. Kurt Boss, I saw you say in the chat, I can't scroll and find it, but that it's hard to find anybody who wasn't connected to the military in the 60s, and you're absolutely right. We just came out of World War II. It was the thing to do, right? Most people were somehow connected to the military. But when you go back and you look at some of these fucking icons, Jim Morrison, his dad was the head of the he wasn't. That was Zappa's dad. Morrison's dad was the admiral who went into the Gulf of Tonkin, right? Like, started that whole fucking fiasco, false flag, you know, bullshit. Like, it's just so mind-melting when you find out all the things that you were told and sold and believed your whole entire life have just been contrived. And, they actually have these controls. Remember when we were told for 20 fucking years that MK Ultra was a conspiracy and it wasn't real? Yeah, and then they had to come out and admit it was real. Oh, but we burned all the documents. You know, like, oh, we got rid of all that stuff. That, you know, it was bad, but it wasn't as bad as you're saying it was. This shit is still ongoing. Yes, they never got rid of it. Yeah, Shanda, Jimmy wanted to reboot against it all. Yeah. The Lizard King. Why did he call himself the Lizard King, right? Especially when you combine the conspiracy about the lizard people that live under LA, right? Do you guys know about that? There's supposedly a whole lizard complex under LA. Crazy conspiracies. We could get into them and melt our minds forever, but we won't. But I just thought if you guys wanted to check that out, that you could get that book on Amazon. There's quite a few other books that kind of speak to that too. But like I said, you can go listen to the interviews with David McGovern. They're pretty interesting, I think. Anyways, moving on. Why is the Baphomet Illuminati queens all going country? We're going country. Because that's a whole demographic of vulnerable people that they can go after. Duh. So there's Madonna. Remember, she went country. Beyonce's gone country. Jay-Z paid more than $20 million to country radio stations to play Beyonce's song so that it could top the Billboard country charts. Oh, that's how this works. They just buy their spot on the Billboard Top 100. That's how they got into country. Well, I know somebody who got into country and they did it the right way. And that is jelly roll, right? Even though I'm sad. I'm sad that they've got jelly. Okay, let's talk about this mousetrap bullshit that dropped yesterday that so many are falling for. And we know the truth. We've known the truth for a while. The Walt Disney Company buys Epstein Island, let's see, March 8, 2024, by Mousetrap News. The Walt Disney Company officially buys Epstein Island. They plan to build a new theme park there as well as making it a stop for cruise ships. In fact, Disney purchased the island for a whopping $3 billion. Bullshit, fake news. Billionaire Stefan Dekoff buys Epstein Island, and this is May 3rd, 2023, and I remember covering it. So when I saw this yesterday, I was like, well, they buy it from the dude who bought it from the dude? Like, no, it was total absolute BS. It's not true. Not true. Fake news, as Trump would say. Yay, we made it to Meme Alley. Let's get our meme on. I don't think the memes are as hot as fresh as they were on Monday, but it happens. Sometimes they stale out. And Cinderella should have lived a happy life with all of her animal friends rather than go with a man who had her try on a shoe because he didn't recognize her without her fucking makeup on. Oh, bravo. She should have ran off with her animal friends. What was she thinking? That's too funny. Oh, you're from Washington. No, I'm from Washington. That's exactly it. I don't live in the big city. I live rural. And Washington State, look, everybody, the Northern Lights. Yeah, we don't get to see it. Look, everybody, a solar eclipse. Yeah, we didn't see that either. Look, everybody, a once-in-a-lifetime comet. Yep, we didn't see that. Look, everybody, a rare planetary alignment. Yep, we couldn't see that. Look, everybody, a giant space aircraft, spaceship. Yeah, nope, we didn't see that either. We don't see shit in Washington State. Why? Because it's always cloudy. That's why. I've lived in Washington State on and off my whole entire life, and I don't think I've ever seen the Northern Lights here. Never once. How sad is that? Very sad. That's just the reality. It's always cloudy in Seattle. Me praying my husband sees the brake lights ahead of us and we don't die because I can't say anything since I already got the you want to drive speech. That's too funny. I was laughing my ass off when I saw this because I do this. I don't care though, because you know how many times I've saved our fucking lives because I did say, hey, that car is stopping. You know, so yeah, I've got the do you want to drive speech many times. And I always say, yeah, let me drive, please. I'm a better driver. Anyway, got a rank on it. Come on, get back where you need to be. There you go. And when you just want to be creative, but all the energy is being used to survive. God, yes. Just trying to survive. It's still so much of your energy. You guys know that. I know you're out there struggling to survive too. But don't let it steal your creativity. Create, create. When the vacuum cleaner goes over a spot of dirt and dust and you hear that crackle, oh, that's the good stuff. Oh, that is the good stuff. Who else has an addiction to vacuuming? I like to vacuum. I like that. You know when you go over a path of rocks and you can hear them all clattering in there that you got the good stuff. And rest in peace, Robin Williams. We miss you. We do. And trying to be a good friend in late stage capitalism, be like, is everything okay? I mean, other than, you know, everything, right? That's what it is. Is he still alive? Ted Danson? I don't know. I haven't seen him in a long time. Probably a whoopee broke him. And, oh, this one's bad. This one's so bad. Let's see. Joe Rogan, CIA, white males. Oh, they're doing ass shots. The CIA is doing ass shots off Joe Rogan. Yeah, very true. Very true. You can't tell me somebody who got $300 million from Spotify and is allowed to go back on YouTube is not somehow controlled. You will never convince me that. You will never. And yeah, I think Joe Rogan says what he wants to say there, but I think that there's influences. Like, maybe you should interview this person or maybe you shouldn't interview that person. My opinion, you can come for me. I'm allowed to think Joe Rogan is a mammy. You know, mainstream alternative media. We've talked about the mammies. They didn't come out of nowhere. And you don't make that kind of money unless you're doing the bidding of somebody. We know that. We know that. This is common thought. I mean, makes sense, right? They're all mammies. Even Alex Jones has got me questioning what he's doing. Government cheese flavored Lay's. Those would be my favorite. They probably taste better than the regular Lay's, but we miss government cheese. You guys know I've reported on this that there is no real cheese in America anymore. Big Pharma has bought out and is supplying the main ingredients to make cheese now. Yeah, it's artificial. It's bioengineered. It's not real. So yeah, the base of your cheese is no longer real, sadly. So that would mean government cheese is probably ruined too, would be my guess. But in the day, government cheese was the way to go. This is super cute. So, oh, wrong button. Okay. Vital update. My Roadrunner porch buddy used to run away if I wanted a picture of him. Now, when he catches a lizard, he knocks on my door and then he parades his catch around and poses. It's amazing. Who's a good little boy, Mr. Meep Meep? Aw, Meep Meep. So cute. I gotta tell you, Roadrunner was one of my favorite cartoons when I was a kid. I loved Roadrunner. Why? Because he always kicked that coyote's ass, right? You could just look at the coyote as the government and us as the Roadrunner. That's kind of what I see here. And let's see. We got our gardening meme for the day. I don't go out much, but I will if these are our plans. Oh, yeah. I want to go dance with the forest animals for sure. How cute. I know. I need to get in my yard. I just have had no time. You guys know. No time, no rest for the wicked. And I got this from Comrade Misty Poon. Let's talk Julian Assange. Tomorrow, it will be the 5-year anniversary of him being locked in Belmarsh for absolutely fucking nothing on bogus charges. We all know it and we hate it. So Comrade Misty says, I was a little hesitant to participate here. I was concerned my very public anti-electoral politic position would distract away from what they are doing. But I'm always willing to stand with others' support of Assange to get the message out. I hope each of these candidates chooses to speak loudly and often to their prospective constituents about Assange and press freedom. So I think that this was a candidate forum. This is Candidates for Assange. This was hosted by friend of the show, Kelly Lane. And yeah, check it out. Missy, I totally get that, you know, you're not into electoral politics because you see through it like so many of us do. But it's so important that Missy be in those spaces and that candidates are out there talking about Assange. So let's hear from Comrade Misty Putin. And like I said, Misty's got a new show, The Misty Winston Show. Go over to YouTube. She's got a channel made. She don't have much over there. It's just the bare bones. If you want to be at the ground level, go follow it. I think she had like 10 followers this morning when I signed up. So go check it out. New show from Misty.
They wanted to drag this out for as long as human. We know that because Julian himself released that information in the Stratfor files. There's an email conversation taking place where they're discussing how to handle their Assange problem. And one of the ways that they discuss is, well, we'll just tie him up in legal stuff for the next 25 years. It's exactly what they're doing. And they're doing it for a multitude of reasons. First and foremost, they wanted to silence him and shut down WikiLeaks, but he's also serving as a warning. He is the proverbial head on a stake outside the castle walls. Yep. He is the warning to all other journalists yep. across the globe and whistleblowers as well. Mm-hmm. That if you come for us, this is what we will do to you. And it's been very effective.
100%. Yay, Misty. And yeah, DC, that's what I'm here for, to let you guys know where our friends and peeps that we follow are and what they're up to. I try to make sure I feature, our comrades in independent media, because that's what it's all about. So make sure you're following, supporting them. And besides, Misty's a fucking riot. Are you kidding? She keeps me laughing all the time. Okay, yay, we made it through this deck, which means I gotta go hop a bus and go grocery shopping. Fun. I never thought I'd be here, but I'm here and I'm just gonna suck it up and love it because, hey, I'm still alive and you're still watching and things are still good. So I haven't actually heard the music for this. So Oz, what is our culinary delight for today? Kyle, you need a wrench. Let me get you a wrench real fast. Oh, other mouse. Welcome. Okay, Kyle just got a wrench too. Let me know if you don't have a wrench. I will throw one at you. And yeah, let's check out what Beauty and the Boomer thumbnail is going to be for Saturday. I like this song. Yeah, thanks. Hit that like. Nice choice, Oz. I lost that love before. Got mad at door. Great choice. But you said try.
just once more. That shows you for the one. Now we're having so much fun. You treated me so kind. I'm about to lose my mind. You made me so happy.
Great choice. Ozzy's got good taste. I know. He does, doesn't he? Okay, so I know there's a surprise at the end of this, and I'm going to save it, and you guys will see it when it it gets rolled out on Friday. So make sure you watch to the very end, because Oz put some special effects in there. I'm not going to blow it on my show, though. I'll let you guys see it for yourself. And today is Wednesday, so happy Silly Wednesday. I didn't have Joey's this morning because I savor my Joey's, and I did the U-band, but I do get Joey's when it's a special occasion. I save that shit. It's like gold to me. And if you want some gold Joey's coffee, make sure you reach out to Oz, and he'll send you the link to order. It's so worth it. You guys know we're always talking about Joey's coffee. A lot of shows sell coffee. Let's just put it that way. A lot of shows sell coffee. But a lot of shows don't have a woman who came from fucking China who knows how to hand pick and hand roast these things and make them amazing. Oh my God. I've never in my life had coffee like Joey's coffee. I will tell you that. And I live in Seattle. We're known for our coffee shops. I've drank a lot of coffee. I even owned a couple of coffee shops in my life. And I'm telling you, I've never had coffee better than Joey's. So I'm not just saying it. It is the truth. If you want to help me out, that would be awesome. There is my donation links. God, donations have been so far and few between. And I know it's not just me. It's everybody. All my friends in independent media, I hear them saying the same thing on their shows. We appreciate what we are getting. It's helping us limp by. Independent media only happens because of your support. All of the shows you watch, whether it be AM Wake Up, whether it be Pasta, whether it be, we are all independent. We don't have sponsors. We don't do ad reads. You're not seeing, you know, commercials for anything on our shows. So every dime that you guys so kindly donate to us, we put back into our shows. And you guys can see by my studio, we've been putting it back into the show. Which just means we're going to go a little longer, right? There's the PayPal for what it's worth. And I got a great closer, but I had to do this setup for the closer. So I'm doing a big 80s closer today. We're going to go do some Nobody's Fool from Cinderella because, hey, we're nobody's fool. We knew nothing was going to happen on Monday. I was going to close Monday's show with Nobody's Fool, but then I found that Pink Floyd closer was much better, I must say. So let's see, the 70s, $5 to see a great band live in concert, $2,100 to see a laptop live. Yeah, did you guys know I was gonna go to Jelly Roll again this year like I did last year? But last year nobody really knew who Jelly Roll was, so tickets were pretty cheap, they were easy to get, upgrades were good because there wasn't a lot of people, they were offering good upgrades. Tried to get tickets for this coming show this summer. Oh my God, general admission, $800. And then, you know, we were all bitching about the prices. You had to be in the nosebleed, back, not being able to even see a little ant on stage. And that was a couple $100. And Jelly Roll comes out and goes, guys, it's not me. I didn't set these prices. I would never do that. I would never charge you that much to come see me. It's these fucking venues and, you know, all of these go-betweens that are selling the tickets. So anyways, I've been priced out of another great artist, and I'm sad about it. I am sad. But that's reality, right? I don't know. I guess these guys will learn. They'll learn that you guys are turning off your audience when people can't come see you. But, you know, it's really funny. I was listening to somebody talking about how the musicians weren't very fucking good in the 60s and 70s. I think it was a part of that Laurel Canyon thing. And that it was all studio players that played on their fucking albums. Because do you remember when you would go to a concert in the 70s or 80s and they sucked? They suck terrible. Like Aerosmith's a good example of it, right? They're not hitting the highs. They don't sound anything like they sound on the album because most of them had studio players in the fucking background. And we just forgave them for it because PA systems suck so bad back then. But sounds better now anyways. Okay, let me shout out the chats real fast, see what's going on, and we will get the hell out of here. I probably need a different mouse. Let's see. Rokfin, what's up? Vaholix, good to see you. Mr. Worthless Eaters hanging out with Jess Week 28. And who else is over here? Jess Week. Oh, you guys are chatting. Birdhouse Blues and Shane Pipe 69. Thank you guys so much for joining me on the Rokfin. Rokfin's actually, or the Rumble. The Rumble actually paid us last month. So you guys can donate over on the Rumble anytime. I know my YouTube channel is not monetized yet. The Beauty and the Boomer is, but not mine. But you guys can always donate over at Beauty and the Boomer Rumble. And Rokfin, thank you guys so much for joining me. Let me get over to that. I got to go around the world. I literally have to take my mouse and go around the world to get to one of my other screens. So Jim was hanging out over there with Tom Copper. Good to see you, Tom. And I know Fred Edwards is hanging out over there because I saw him tweeting my stuff out earlier. Himcar, good to see you, Himcar. What's up? DC, you're everywhere. DC. Lynn, good to see you. Lynn, you're in the Northwest with me. Yeah, we are in the wipeout tsunami zone. It's ready to go, isn't it? And Popeye couldn't hang out for the show, but that's okay. We love all the peeps. And, oh, Grapentine, welcome. I'm going to have to throw you a wrench once I can get the right mouse over there. Go back around the world. There we go. Okay, Kurt Boss, thank you so much for joining us. And Grapentine, I'm throwing you a wrench right now. Oh, welcome. You have become a mod. Bad Cookies is hanging out along with DC. DC's everywhere, like I said. And Cobra Commander. Hi, Cobra Commander. I was a big fan. Kyle's mommy made it today. Haven't seen you in a while. Good to see you in the chat. Ozzy, good to see you. And Mastermind. And let's see who else is in here. Kill Your E, Greg Rose. Good to see you. Jilly Love. Kurt Boss, I got you. Bad Cookies. Got Bad Cookies. And Cowboy Kitty. Good to see you, Cowboy Kitty. Okay, I think that's everybody that was chatting at the end of the show. Anyways, I'm getting the hell out of here. I will be back Saturday night for Beauty and the Boomer with my buddy Oz. You guys have to join us for that. And we are going out with a Cinderella cover. Let's see, who is this? This is Sarg, S-G-A-R. Nobody's Fool. This is a great Cinderella cover. And yeah, I'm out of here. And you are always welcome at the trailer park. And see you next time.
Count the falling tears that fall before my eyes. Seem like a thousand years since we broke the ties.